leaves have turned in Philadelphia. Veterans Stadium is sold out as the hated Cowboys come to the city of brotherly love. The Eagles and the Dallas Cowboys, one of the most intense rivalries in the NFL. I'm Pat Summerall here with John Madden. And John, let's get to the business at hand. Let's talk about Dallas first. What do they have to do to win this game?
Well, you know, I think anytime you talk about the Dallas Cowboys offensively and they play a big game, they have to do two things. They have to run the ball to Emmitt Smith, and that's going to be tougher because they don't have Darrell Johnston, the Moose, anymore to block for him, and they have to throw the ball to Michael Irvin. And then on defense, we're talking to the defensive coordinator last night of the Dallas Cowboys, Dave Campo, and he just says one guy. He says, we have to stop Ricky Waters.
And from a Philadelphia viewpoint, what do the Eagles have to do?
Well, you know, Ray Rhodes knows that if he is going to do any good, he has to be able to run the ball, and that means not only Ricky Waters, but Charlie Garner. He likes to get him in there and get him some touches. Then if they can get that eight man up, then they have to get the ball out to Irving Fryer.
Whatever they do, they're going to do with a wet ball because it's raining right now. And coming up, it's the Dallas Cowboys and the Philadelphia Eagles from Veterans Stadium. And John and I'll be back for the opening kickoff when Fox NFL Sunday continues after these messages from your local station.
You're watching Fox NFL Sunday. And now, the Erickson Countdown continues.
The weather, the temperature 49 degrees. The winds, not too much of a factor. East 8 miles an hour. The forecast is for rain. It's not raining at the moment. The Cowboys have won the toss. They'll receive, and Herschel Walker, the hero of last week's win over Jacksonville for Dallas, back deep for the Cowboys. Dallas road record 1-3. The Philadelphia home record 3-0. Something's got to give. Special teams, kickoff returns for Dallas. They rank third in the NFL. The Philadelphia kickoff coverage is last.
This is one of the matchups that Ray Rhodes was worried about yesterday, right here.
Bonio's kick to Walker at the goal line. Brett Marion, beg your pardon. Marion breaks out of the pack. Bonio missed, but that's what Ray Rhodes feared so much.
And he had reason to, didn't he?
Did he ever? Troy Aikman won 7 out of the last 9 against the Eagles. In front of him, Hegeman in place of Tune, Newton, Shiver, Allen, and Williams. Emmitt Smith and Herschel Walker, the two backs, Anthony Miller and Michael Irvin wide, and Eric Bjornson, the tight end. Irvin comes left with Miller inside in the slot. Walker in front of Smith in the backfield. Aikman, the quarterback. On first down, for Michael Irvin, incomplete. Well covered. The Eagle defense. The front four, Mamula, Rhett Hall, Hollis Thomas, and Greg Jefferson. The three linebackers, Thomas Willis in the middle, and Darren Smith, the ex-Cowboy. Dimery, Dawkins, Zordich, and Vincent, the secondary. Dimery in place of Taylor. Smith gets first down yardage, but a penalty marker down. Brian Dawkins made the stop.
Number 59 is lined up in the neutral zone for the defense. That penalty is applied. First down.
Jerry Austin indicating the penalty against the Eagles. The Cowboys decline it. Emmitt Smith got enough for a first down.
Well, he just ran that lead play right in behind big Larry Allen and big Eric Williams. And if you're going to run, that's not a bad play.
Two tight ends set up this time. Smith, the ball carrier again. A yard. And he is pushed backward. Led by Greg Jefferson. First on the scene.
And the other thing is James Willis was right there. You know, any time that you're going to to take and get outside the off-tackle area, you have to keep that middle linebacker from flowing. And that's exactly what happens. Watch the flow here once you start to that side. You see the linebackers flow there. Now watch Willis come in and make the move right there and get up the field.
Second and nine. Aikman back to throw. Shuffled out of the pocket. The pass incomplete. Irvin lost the handle.
Well, you know, one of the things that the Eagles talked about was keeping Troy Aikman backing up and not letting him get into a rhythm. Now, the Cowboys are doing an interesting thing here, Pat. They're bringing in John Flannery on passing downs to play right guard. Then they're taking right guard, their best offensive lineman, Larry Allen, and they're moving him to left tackle. This is something you seldom see, movement of offensive linemen changing position on different plays.
Ultimately, that's probably where Larry Allen will wind up. But this is brought about by the injury to Tune. Pass up to Emmitt Smith. Close to first down yardage, stopped by Willie Clark. And you know, it's close.
And that's not, I mean, here's the area that they're worried about. They're worried about Mike Mamula. So they put Larry Allen over here, let him block. Then they keep the tight end in the backfield and get a chip. So they are not going to let pressure come from this side. What? There's the block. There's the chip. And Larry Allen doesn't need a lot of chipping.
No, he doesn't.
The Eric Bjornsson, he stays in there. They are not going to let Mike Mamula get off the line of scrimmage on passing downs.
You know, John, that seems like an insignificant thing to move from right guard to left tackle. But going from the right side of the offensive line to the left side is a big move.
Well, that's tough because everything that is inside on one side is outside in the other and vice versa. And when you get trained, you know, to keep your left foot in, your right foot back, and all those things, then you go to the other side, you have to do the opposite of everything. This is an interesting thing right here, Pat. The Cowboys are fourth down. This is the area that, you know, Troy Aikman last week ran a quarterback sneak, and I would think this would be the area that he would run another quarterback sneak.
Very short yardage to get a Cowboy first quarterback sneak, as John Madden said. And he's close. It is a first down.
I think one of the, you know, you're going to talk about the Cowboys and missing Moose Johnston, who was the best blocking fullback in all of football. And I think in some of these short yardage, goal line, those running type things where they used to have the lead play, they are going to lose. Now, Herschel Walker gives them something else. I mean, he's a pass receiver. He has more speed. But when you talk about just an extra blocker, you do not get that with Herschel Walker.
Walker in front of Emmitt Smith. Aikman back to throw it. Going deep for Irvin. He had it. Vincent knocked it loose. Flag on the play.
And they are playing Troy Vincent wherever Michael Irvin goes. We see Michael Irvin line up on the right side. Troy Vincent lines up over there. See him on the left side. Troy Vincent lines up on him on that side. Remember, it used to be Bobby Taylor that always covered Michael Irvin. In today's game, it's Troy Vincent.
Well, this is something that goes on more and more frequently, that contact and a bumping between receiver and defensive back.
Yeah, and Michael Irvin is one of the biggest pushers, you know, of offensive receivers.
Two fouls.
Number 88 of the offense pushes off.
That's what they got.
We have number 23 of the defense not playing the ball and interference. Both penalties offset. Replay first down.
Well, that's both guys playing against each other. What they're saying is Michael Irvin pushed off, and it's going to get right there is the push off. Now when the ball's in the air, Troy Vincent can't touch him. So that was the interference.
They said he wasn't playing the ball.
No, he wasn't, and he was playing Michael Irvin, but not only playing Michael Irvin, he was pushing Michael Irvin.
So they'll repeat the down. Situation remains the same at the Eagle 30. Emmitt Smith. Emmitt going sideways through the hole, stopped by Rhett Hall. He's still got about 3 yards.
Sometimes you have to do that. You have to, you know, get out of square and go into what you call slither. That's exactly what Emmitt Smith got out of square and into slither.
Well, you slither close to Halloween, I guess.
You know, Troy Aikman hates to throw a wet football, too. I mean, if there's anything that gets into his mind or bothers him in a football field, it's a wet football.
Two tight end setup. Fake is to Emmett Smith. Pass is incomplete for Scott Galbraith. That's one of those two tight ends.
That's one new thing, you know, that the Dallas Cowboys are doing now that for years we never saw them do was run a bootleg.
Here comes Flannery again.
Yeah, you see Flannery. You can see the rain. It's starting to rain harder now. Flannery comes in, plays right guard again for Larry Allen. Larry Allen will move out to left tackle because of all the offensive line positions, the most important one in pass protection on long yardage is this one right here. The left tackle,
especially with a right-handed quarterback, which of course Aikman is. Aikman off to run, got a first down, got more, slides at about the 13-yard line. First down, Cowboys.
One thing these Eagles want to do is they want to pressure Troy Aikman. They know that they had to do that. They want to hit him on every play. And you don't expect this. I mean, Troy Aikman himself didn't expect it, as evidenced by the slide at the end of the play. Good coverage on the right side. So that was darn near a coverage sack, but they didn't get the sack. Now watch Troy, how he tries to end that. I mean, he almost got that right leg caught up under there.
That was not your picture-perfect slide.
That was what you called downright ugly.
Here's Emmett Smith. And Emmett ducks under the tacklers at about the 14. The red zone offense, I'm sure they're tired of hearing about this, but it's been a problem. Look at their touchdown percentage since 1994. 65% then, 32% down. It's been going down steadily every year.
And if they're tired of hearing about it, then the way to stop the talk is do something about it. And this is the problem that they have right there. First and 10, they run and they gain none yards.
Nothing.
That's the problem. They used to be able to run better in this area.
Hand off to Walker this time. There's nothing there for him. Maybe a yard. Never got underway.
I think they tried to just slide it into Walker right in here, thinking that they could get a crease in there. But this end is playing too tight there. They expected that there'd be a crease in there, and that's the old beer play. You know, and then they had the possibility of an option off that to Emmett Smith, but there was the line was too tight to run the beer in there. There was no hole in there.
This is the 12th play of this drive since they received the kickoff upcoming. Three wide receivers this time. Miller is to the left. Flag on the play. The pass is incomplete. Intended for Miller.
Yeah, someplace, you know, they always say this every week, someplace Anthony Miller is going to have to step up, and he hasn't yet. If they're going to double Michael Irvin, somewhere he has to make some plays.
Offside, number 97 of the defense.
They'll get another chance.
Repeat third down.
Brett Hall was offside, so the Cowboys will get another crack on third down. Third and four, this will be.
Yeah, now they can run that slant because they picked up the 5 yards on the penalty. I think that slant on that play, even had they completed it, they would have been short because Charles Dimery really had pretty good coverage on Anthony Miller.
Almost picked it off. Three wide receivers set up again. This time it's Stepford Williams to the left. Aikman back. Incomplete, intended for Bjornson. Only got one hand out. Brian Dawkins, the coverage on Bjornson.
Yeah, and I'll tell you the other thing. Michael Zordich came on a blitz from Troy Aikman's backside, and he wasn't blocked, and that's the thing that made Aikman get rid of the ball. We talked to the Eagles. That's what they wanted to do. And, in fact, Ray Rose told me yesterday that he would expect that they would blitz almost every passing down against the Cowboys today.
Richie Cunningham, 21 out of 23, leads the NFL in field goals. A lot more field goals than extra points. That's not a good sign. Cunningham's kick is good, so the Cowboys take the lead 3-0 on their opening drive.
Fox. NFL Sunday is brought to you by Southwest Airlines, with fares so low you have the freedom to fly. By Oldsmobile and your local Oldsmobile retailers. And by the Principal Financial Group, for over a century, your edge in retirement insurance and investment products.
Halloween approaches. Dallas leads 3-0. Hey. The ball 5 minutes and 33 seconds.
No, I was just going to say, you can't beat a pumpkin or a pumpkin patch, can
nope,
you?
No, you can't. That time.
Yep, go out to the pumpkin patch and get a pumpkin.
Deuce Staley back deep for the Eagles. He'll be going set to kick it off for Dallas. Line drive kickoff. Handled by one of the up men. Ball loose. Let's see who got it. The Eagles got it back. It was Jimmy Johnson, I believe, who returned it and lost it. 3-0 Dallas.
I stand here carrying on a great tradition. I've been Coors Light, like my father, and his father before him. Frost brewed and Rocky Mountain cold makes people feel refreshed. I think my forefathers would respect that. Not for them, I wouldn't be who I am today. Bob Smith, the fourth, beer man. This one's for you, Grandpa.
I'm not your grandpa.
Coors Light!
There's no question that computers open up entirely new worlds. But what about children who live in a world that can't afford personal computers? Fortunately, as of today, we'll never have to ask that question again. Network computers allow everyone to join the information age. And we'd like to say, welcome. Oracle, enabling the information age.
You're buying a car. You know exactly which cars you want and which cars you don't want. But there are still cars out there that you don't know that you do want. Recently, Oldsmobile has come out with so many new models, they might not be on your list yet. They should be. So before you buy, find out all you can. Come to Oldsmobile's 100th anniversary premiere and drive them. Find out.
Halloween Scream! With a brand new episode, plus two classic tales.
Darn it, Fred.
It's the Simpsons Scarathon tonight at 7, 6 Central on Fox.
Charles Emmanuel, the rookie from West Virginia. Here's what happened a moment ago. That tee blocking number 22.
There he is. There he is right there blocking, and watch as Jimmy Johnson comes in there. He runs right into him. Emmanuel's leg gets caught up under the pile.
He's the backup safety for the Eagles.
Yeah, he played last week. He played for Brian Dawkins, who is a regular free safety who was out.
Rodney Pete has had a stop with the Cowboys, but he opens and hands off to Ricky Waters. Let's look at Philadelphia's offense. As I mentioned, Rodney Pete was the starting quarterback. His second start after Ty Detmer did it most early in the year. In front of him, Mayberry, Panos, Everett, Beckles, and Brooks. And with him in the backfield, Waters and Kevin Turner, one of the best, Irving Fryer, remarkable, Michael Timpson, and Jason Dunn.
They have Charlie Garner in there with them now.
That's Garner bouncing off to his left. It'll be third and short. Let's look at the Dallas defense. They're missing a lot of people. Shante Carver, Antonio Anderson in place of Chad Hennings, Casillas, and Tolbert. The front four, when they're in a four. Coakley, Strickland, and Randall Godfrey, the linebackers. And the secondary, without Darren Woodson, will be Sanders, Marion, Stoutmeyer, and Smith. Third and two. And here's Rodney Pete back to throw. And he has the completion of Irving Fryer and a first down close to midfield.
Yeah, there's a guy that's an amazing guy. Irving Fryer, you look at him, and he's been in the league for 14 years. And, you know, at some point, guys usually start to look their age or look like they've been in the league or caught that many passes or whatever, but he doesn't look that way.
No.
He still looks, he moves, he acts, he plays like a young guy. In fact, Ray Rhodes says he thinks he's the toughest guy in the whole team.
Amazing to play a position like wide receiver as long as he has it played so effectively. He retreated, tried to get it out to Turner, incomplete. Knocked down by Godfrey. Shante Carver, who had opened a defensive end over on the Dallas sideline. Broderick Thomas has taken his place. Emmanuel being administered to on the other side. Rodney Pete, second and 10. Puts Fryer in motion. Hand off to Water. Water is hit behind the line by Dexter Coakley first. There's Emmanuel. Into the wagon, headed for X-rays.
Did you see that Dexter Coakley on that play?
Yes.
One thing you can't do when you have quick linebackers, and the Cowboys have quick linebackers in Dexter Coakley and Randall Godfrey, is you can't spend a lot of time dancing in the hole. And Ricky Waters knows that.
Yep.
And he spent too much time dancing in the hole, and Dexter Coakley speared him in the middle of a dance.
Third and long. Deep retreats. Fryer makes a one-handed grab behind him.
How in the heck did
what
he
a
do
catch.
That? Irving Fryer had already passed that point. Rodney Pete throws the ball behind him. Fryer just reaches back with his left hand and catches the ball one-handed. This is something.
It's amazing.
He's going to run it in there. The ball is behind him. He just reaches back. It grabs up there, snags it with his one hand.
And scooped it in. First down, Eagles.
The guy covered him was the rookie Omar Stoutmeyer. He said, I never saw a play like that at Fresno State.
He never saw Irving Fryer play at Nebraska either. Here's Ricky Waters. No gain. Hit by Strickland. Right now for a McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Hey, Pat, Terry Kirby took a screen pass 82 yards last week. Look at the counter screen. New wrinkle for San Francisco. The Garrison Hurst, 19 yards to pay dirt. 49ers on top, 7-0. Back to Philadelphia. Pat Summerall and John Madden.
Like the 49ers get better every week, and we'll see them next week when Dallas travels to the Bay Area. Two tight ends set up for the Eagles this time. Dallas leading here at the bench, 3-0. Incomplete. Intended for Michael Timpson, covered by Kevin Smith.
They want an interference call on Kevin Smith on this. You watch Michael Timpson. He starts to the inside in motion, then he goes to the outside, then back to the inside, and again, that ball was thrown behind him.
Behind, yes.
Rodney Pete has some completions, but he doesn't have many good passes.
Third and 10.
Let's try that one to Fryer again.
Yeah, that scoop one behind him.
Because that's one place that the Cowboy pass defense has always been vulnerable, is ins and crosses.
Fryer split wide to the right. Pete looks in that direction. The pass was almost picked off by Kevin Smith. He saw it coming.
Well, Rodney Pete smiling on that one because he knew that he got a break. He was trying to get that ball in there, but here's Kevin Smith. Now, you watch his eyes. You see, he's looking into the backfield. He's watching Rodney Pete. So when that ball is thrown, he really gets a better jump on going to the ball than Irving Fryer did.
He was there.
See, that's the thing. When you're playing zone and you're playing off like that, you can watch the quarterback, read his drop, then read his eyes, and get a pretty good jump, as Kevin Smith did.
Chris Bonio from 52 yards out with Hutton holding. Bonio won't get it there, I don't believe. Short, wide right. No good. They'll bring it back to the line of scrimmage. The Cowboys will take over with the lead, 3-0.
Oh,
meet Sean Graham, veteran stuntman. This is how he lives. This is what he drives. What else would he drive? Chevy S10, like a rock.
Okay, let's see. You have your Germanic roach, your yucca roach, your classic water roach spitters.
Let's see what we're dealing with here. Denny, give me the Widowmaker. 99. Oh, boy. You're the most stubborn of all breeds.
Denny, to the truck, now!
Trust me, I'm very good at what I do.
Tonight, has Hank Hill made a pact with the devil?
It just tears my heart out.
A screaming new King of the Hill, tonight at 8:30, 7:30 Central.
Irving Fryer. That catch he made a moment ago, that was something.
Yeah, I mean, you just have to look again. Yeah, I mean, you see guys make one-hand catches behind, but that was what you call a one-hand snag. He just snagged that thing right out of the air. The Eagles didn't get any points out of it, but... Well, that was a heck of a play by Irving Fryer.
And a big first down. Walker on the move. Aikman down. Rushed by Greg Jefferson. And a red haul.
Yeah, William Thomas had very good coverage out there and Herschel Walker. And that's what Aikman is trying to do. See, he has to bring the ball back. He's trying to get out to Herschel right there. See it? Then he had to hold it. Then he looked upfield. Now that's a coverage sack. Because, in fact, he looked once. He was trying to go short to Herschel Walker. He couldn't do it. He looked deep. He couldn't find anything there. He had to bring the ball down, and he got sacked.
Seven pass plays, five blitzes. This is Emmett Smith. And Emmett picks up a few. Back to the original line of scrimmage over on the Philadelphia sideline. The offensive center, the offensive guard, Ian Beckles, and Ricky Waters.
Yeah, they always sit the way they line up. You know, there's the center, and then Beckles is the right guard, so he sits right next to him. They're looking at the imaging plays, you know, to see how the Cowboys will line up on different plays. Again, at left tackle.
Three wide receivers set up for the Cowboys. That's Bjornsson. Moving. And here's Aikman. Pass is caught by Michael Irvin. Good throw, good pattern, good catch. That'll usually get it done.
Well, one thing, you know, that Ray Rhodes will always tell the guy, when you play against Michael Irvin, you have to be physical. It's not Bobby Taylor, it's Troy Vincent out there. He's going to bump you, he's going to push you. You have to knock him around. Of course, that's tougher to do than it is to talk about it, because Troy Vincent did all those things and Michael Irvin still caught the ball.
The fullback is Nicky Sualua this time, and Smith behind him, and no gain.
See, one of the things, you know, with the fullback, he has to make a quick decision. I mean, he has to find that hole and get in there, and Sualua just made a little hesitation, and that little hesitation is the thing that's going to slow up Emmett Smith too, because watch Sualua as he starts. He's going to make a little hesitation. He's not sure whether he goes here or out, and then in that little hesitation, that also hesitates. You see him?
Yep.
He started in, then he had to go back out, then that also made Emmett Smith hold the ball for a while. That's why they didn't get any gain.
Hesitation by both. Sualua stays in to block. Aikman under pressure, and down he goes. William Thomas. And Aikman still down.
William Thomas made a couple of big plays in this series. One, he was the guy that was guarding Herschel Walker when Aikman tried to throw to him early. That time, he just went right by Emmett Smith.
Aikman gets up slowly.
He's going to come from the outside here, and you're going to see Emmett Smith try and block him. There he is right there. He just goes right through Emmett Smith and grabs Troy Aikman.
Aikman down on one knee. As you look at the end of that play, let's see what happened. Aikman got up very slowly and went back down on one knee.
Where's your father?
You don't want to know.
Here he comes.
Whoa! Whoa!
Whoa! Watch out, Dad!
Whoa!
Yeah, yeah. There we go.
Introducing Chevy Venture, the only minivan that offers a remote-controlled door. Pretty convenient, huh?
Oh, Dad.
What?
The all-new Chevy Venture is here.
Let's go.
Good idea.
I never met a quarterback. Never. Met a quarterback I like.
I want to take him out.
The sissies, they're a bunch of pretty boys.
Pretty boys.
No ifs, ands, buts about it.
A bunch of, watch out. Easy to intimidate.
I can taste it when I hit him hard.
Easier to dominate.
Just a bunch of prima donnas.
Take out the prima donna.
Boom!
Prima donna. That's what I'm paid to do.
I'm just shocked they know the word prima donna.
Oh.
Nike Play Corps presents.
Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land and of the free and the home of the brave.
Unless you see this episode, you won't be ready.
Stop!
For the season premiere of The X-Files. The X-Files, tonight at 9, 8 Central on Fox.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Pizza Hut. Enjoy today's game with the Edge Pizza, new from Pizza Hut. 16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge?
Watch Troy Aikman here. Watch the hit that Jimmy Jones is going to get out right there. You see him, he had William Thomas had him by the back, and then Jimmy Jones hit him right in the head. And that head just snapped right back.
And that's Wade Wilson at quarterback for Dallas now. Retreats with no warm-up to throw. Pass complete to Eric Bjornsson. Not nearly enough for a first down. There's Herschel Walker. That's why Sualua stayed in the game at fullback. Walker, I don't know what happened to him.
Well, the last play that we saw Herschel Walker on, it was on that pass that Troy Aikman was trying to throw to him when William Thomas had him covered.
So Aikman and Walker both out. And unless I'm wrong, I saw George Hageman limping a moment ago as well. Mark Say fields the punt at about the 20-yard line, about the 18 make it. That's Troy Aikman under the Cowboy hood.
Yeah, and it was the hit. William Thomas really started the sack, and then Jimmy Jones, in fact, Jimmy Jones, the ex-Cowboy, he comes around, and if you'll just watch, here's Thomas, and then you'll see Jimmy Jones come around. Here comes Jimmy Jones right here, and watch when he goes helmet to helmet right there, and that how that just snapped Troy Aikman's head back.
That had to make a very loud noise, and that was a pretty good pop. Here's Rodney Pete. Irving Fryer. To about the 24.
You know,
Strickland made the stop. Excuse me.
No, I was just going to say, Pat, the interesting thing, we saw that Rodney Pete and Irving Fryer were talking about that play, and it was darn near intercepted the last time by the Cowboys, and they talked about it, and they made that adjustment. It looked like he went inside a little more and shortened it down because, remember the last time they threw it, Kevin Smith almost intercepted it.
Should have been an interception, as a matter of fact. Very close. Second down, about four. He gets to Waters, and he won't get it. Troy Aikman over on the sideline. They're still looking at him, still checking him.
Yeah, he went down, Pat. Watch him right here. He got up, and then he thought he was okay. And then there's a point when you stand up and the stuff doesn't work properly. He realized that he wasn't, and he took a knee again. They're giving him the test now.
That's Herschel Walker in front of him in a T-shirt. Here's Rodney Pete on third. And the rush comes. And Pete is taken down. Tony Tolbert and Tony Casillas.
Yeah, Tony Tolbert was the first guy. He went right by Barrett Brooks. Brooks barely got a hand on him.
Dallas leads 3-0. We're in the first quarter. Dallas 3, Philadelphia nothing. We'll start the second quarter with the Eagles about to punt, the Cowboys about to get the ball, and Wade Wilson is the quarterback. Dallas punt returns are second, mostly because of Deion Sanders.
And if he gets his hands on the ball with 10 yards of separation, this could be very, very interesting.
He says there's always a seam. You just have to find it. Ray Rhodes has told his punter, Tommy Hutton, I don't care how far you kick it, just keep it up there a long time so we can get down under it. Blocked by Brock Marion. He was there first. They put the heat on Hutton, and Dallas takes over in great shape. Recovered by Kavika Pittman.
That Tom Hutton was worried about getting the hang time, and he didn't get the ball off. That's just pressure straight up the middle. Oh, he didn't even have a chance. Brock Marion almost beat the ball there. Watch Brock Marion. He's going to come straight up the middle right there. He comes from the outside. Then he straightens up and comes right up. And that is slow. I mean, by the time he gets the ball and gets it rotated, Brock Marion is there and almost passed him by.
Yeah. If he didn't get it, Stoutmeyer was there. He probably could have blocked it.
Oh, Tom Hutton was awfully slow on that. You should be able to get that off.
Sherman Williams is the ball carrier to the Philadelphia 25. Darren Smith made the stop.
And if there's any area, you know, we talked about the, you know, you always talk about the offense and the defense, but if there's any area that the Cowboys have a big, big advantage, it's in special teams. The Cowboys have very good special teams. The Eagles do not have good special teams.
And the difference really does show up.
I mean, you start the opening kickoff of the game.
Yeah.
I mean, the Cowboys brought it almost back to midfield, and then they get the punt. They block the punt, and they do all those things that the Eagles don't do.
That was Cowboys special team coach Joe Avezzano. Here's Wade Wilson back to throw. Wilson throws outside to Michael Irvin. Irvin out of bounds, the Dallas first down.
Michael Irvin again being covered by Troy Vincent, and that time he runs a crossing pattern. You see, they move Michael Irvin around, too. He starts in motion, then he's going to come up, then he's going to run this way to his right across the field, and then he just runs away from Troy Vincent. See, he starts up, then he starts in, then he goes back to the outside, and by moving him around like that, moving him in motion and then bringing him in and back, you don't get a good bump on him.
Wade Wilson. Walker is back in the game. The handoff is to Sherman Williams inside the 10 to about the 9. The word on Walker was that he has a neck strain, and obviously he's back in the game. The word on Aikman is that he, too, has a neck strain, and his return we're not sure about.
Yeah, I don't know that if his head is completely clear either. I mean, he may have a neck strain, but in addition to that, his head hasn't cleared up. You can just tell by looking at it.
Second and 7 at the 10 for Dallas. They lead 3-0. Here's Wilson. Pass is caught by Anthony Miller. And he works his way to about the 6. Wade Wilson, with no warm-up, looks pretty sharp.
Well, anytime you've been in this league for 17 yeah. years, you don't need a lot of warm-up, because over your career, you've done a lot of warming up.
That's the truth.
Wade Wilson's been to a lot of training camps. He's been on a lot of practice fields, and he's been doing this for a long time. And that's what your backup has to be able to do. Not have a lot of practice, not get a lot of reps, but if the starter comes down, you'll come in and take over the game plan.
He hasn't been in the bullpen warming up. He came off the bench cold. The pass right through the arms of Herschel Walker.
Yeah, Wade Wilson did his part on that when he hits Anthony Miller on the second half. Then he hits right here. This is a perfect throw right there. I mean, it just goes right through Herschel Walker's hands. You have to be able, because you want that thing led. You
yep.
don't want that one thrown behind you. You want it where you can just catch it in stride and keep it going. It went right through Herschel Walker's hands.
A little short arm, as they call it. Cunningham for the field goal. And Dallas leads 6-0.
You found some quiet, you got some room.
Time to enjoy life, and none too soon.
So kick your feet up,
and pull your feet up. Stop making whoopee.
You got the moves, your second wind.
Oh, the ride is thrilling, so let the fun begin.
You've earned it all, folks.
And here's the combo for making whoopee.
The new 98 DeVille, for the time of your life.
Just a glance, it happened. Love came looking for me.
Get out of my way!
Dockers. Khaki. Evander Holyfield beat Mike Tyson. Then he beat him again. He beat Foreman and Bo, too. He beat everybody. Everybody except IBF champion Michael Moorer. Holyfield, Moorer 2. World Heavyweight Championship. One of 4 championship fights coming soon. Sponsored by Budweiser. Live on pay-per-view from the Mirage. Evander, you beat everybody. Except. Call your cable or satellite company.
NFL Sunday is brought to you by Cadillac DeVille, for the time of your life. By Pizza Hut. Enjoy today's game with the Edge Pizza, new from Pizza Hut. 16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge? And by Shell, moving at the speed of light.
Veterans Stadium, Aikman headed for the locker room. Word to us from the bench was that he has a strained neck.
And we saw him sitting on the yep. bench, and he kept grabbing that neck area.
Deuce Staley. Zap for the Eagle to about the 28.
You know, one thing is that should fire up the Eagles. I mean, anytime that you have a player like Troy Aikman, who's the you know the big quarterback for the other team, and you see him walking off the field, you know that you come into the game thinking you had a pretty good chance. And then when you see this, you have to think, now we got him. Now we got him where we want him. You know, let's go get him. Let's go get these guys. If they've ever been vulnerable, they're never more vulnerable than they are right now.
Well, Aikman has left the arena. This is a pitch back to Ricky Waters. A lot of shoulder movement, but not many yards.
Well, you know, he tried to go inside in the first quarter. They've been trying to get the ball to Ricky Waters to get some running established, and they've tried to do it inside, and they haven't been able to. So now they're just moving it outside, figuring, well, if there's nothing inside, maybe we can get to the outside. And any time you run outside at the Cowboys, you always run to your left, their right, and try and take advantage of this guy, Deion Sanders, right there.
Three wide receivers. Pete to Fryer, who makes the catch. Again, the ball was kind of behind him, but he still came up with it.
Yeah, Irving Fryer and Rodney Peete both said, you know, that we are going to run these things, that you can run inside patterns. You can run slants, like right there, and you can run crossing patterns against Deion. But Rodney Peete better get it out in front of Fryer, and that could be a bigger play. Rodney Peete's been a little off throwing behind his receivers most of this game.
Third, about a half yard, two tight ends set up for Philadelphia. Waters with the ball. He got enough for the first. Looked like a little more might develop out of that, but it didn't.
Yeah, Fred Strickland stepped up and took it away. It looked like there was a little hole there, and then Cowboy middle linebacker Fred Strickland did what he was supposed to do and just stepped up there. Not in time to stop it from getting to be a first down, but in time to stop it from being anything more than that.
First and 10, Eagles. Three wide receivers set up for the Eagles. And Fryer is the man in motion. Here's Rodney Peete to throw it. Overthrew Ricky Waters. Went right through his hand. Screen pass set up.
The screen pass is getting to be a much bigger player, making a comeback in the National Football League. We saw that earlier thing of the 49ers running a screen, and this is going to be Ricky Waters where he goes here, and then see on a screen you fake like you're blocking, and then you go out to your right or left and get behind your lineman. That time, as you said, the ball just went right through Ricky Waters' hand. In fact, the ball went through, then he closed his hand.
Yeah.
You misjudged that one.
Charlie Garner split wide to the left. Here's Rodney Peete. Pass complete to Irving Fryer. About eight. Charlie Williams made the stop on Fryer.
Yeah, I mean, Irving Fryer is just such a big, strong guy that if you're big and strong, you can run hooks and you can run slants, anything to the inside. See him push off here, just run a slant.
Yeah.
He just comes up and pushes and then takes off inside. In fact, he says, you know, officials are letting wide receivers get away with more and more, seems like every game. So he's taking as much as they'll get him.
Third and two, Peete rolls right, throws to Fryer, who let the ball get right through his hand. I don't think he was expecting it so quickly.
Well, again, you know, he should, because it was a third and short, and that was kind of a play that's designed to pick up a first down on that situation.
And they would have had it.
Yeah, it was a sprint out. Rodney Peete sprinted out, and it's going to be a pass that's thrown quicker.
Deion Sanders standing back at about the 14-yard line. Hutton, whose first punt was blocked by Brock Marion. A little bit quicker this time. Short kick. Down at about the 26, a flag on the play back at the line of scrimmage.
That wasn't much of a punt, but it was 26 yards.
Holding, and it's going to be against Dallas, and that'll give the Eagles a first down.
Tom Hutton's probably the most relieved guy, or he'll probably be glad when this game's over. He doesn't have to play the Cowboys anymore.
10 yards. First down.
Jerry Austin again, the referee. First down, Eagles. You can see the rain driving down. Eureka Pittman, number 97. Dallas 6, the Eagles nothing, 9:22 left.
It says here, the internet is the future of business. We have to be on the internet. Why? Doesn't say.
If it were a guy's world, this would be your 9-to-5, and you'd always be cool. But in the real world, guys sweat 40% more than women. Guys need the protection of Speed Stick antiperspirant. Speed Stick, protection just for the guy.
I hit 10 golf balls in the woods. My driver's in there too. My best drive all day long was to the drive-thru.
Did somebody say McDonald's?
the new 98 DeVille for the time of your life.
Join the Fox NFL Sunday pregame team live from San Francisco as they preview the Cowboys Niners. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 Pacific.
Watch Kavika Pittman. He's number 97. He's going to get the hole. Now, the Cowboys get the ball back because the penalty where he holds is after the ball's kicked. See, the ball was kicked. Now watch Pittman right there. He's going to pull his guy down. You see him right there? There's the hold right there. So they're saying it was a post-possession penalty. Therefore, the Cowboys get the ball.
They at first said it was an Eagle first down. Then it was a post-possession foul. And it was a Cowboy first down after the penalty. The pass from Wilson to Walker again is incomplete on first down, Cowboys.
So. Yeah, they're trying to throw those flat or short passes to Herschel Walker, and the Eagles are defending them well. I mean, the balls are thrown well, and you have to catch those passes, but the defenders are right there waiting for them, like Charles Dimery was on that play.
Second and 10. Pitch back to Emmitt Smith. Emmitt Smith outside the 30 at Dallas, first down behind Larry Allen. Mike Mamula made the stop from the other side in pursuit, but good blocking by the Cowboys.
Yeah, that was good blocking, and Emmitt Smith didn't finish it off. You know, and that's the thing where I think Emmitt Smith is a little different this year. Is you got that run and you got good blocking, there's no one there, and now when you get here, now finish it off. Now just run through stuff. Don't get knocked out of bounds and get knocked around like that. I mean, just finish it off and try and score a touchdown.
First and 10, handoff to Emmitt. Smith picks up about 3, crosses the 35, stopped by James Willis.
Yeah, you know, they used to block a lot better. I mean, the offensive line of the Cowboys was better, and Emmitt Smith would break more tackles. It seems like now when he gets there and that first group gets him, that's going to be the end of the run, where, you know, a couple years ago, that wasn't the end of the run. That was some start of some pretty good action.
Second down, Walker on the move. The Eagles showing blitz. Emmitt Smith tackled just as he headed up field. Hollis Thomas made the stop.
What happened is they really went an overload on the side of the lead. They saw the side that Herschel Walker was on, and he would have to be the lead. So the Eagle defense goes and overloads that side. So now they force him into a cutback. Watch when Herschel Walker comes over here. Watch what that defense does there. Now they're all bunched up over there, and that forces Emmitt Smith to cut back, and he cuts back right into Hollis Thomas.
Third down. Wilson back to throw. Wade Wilson's chased. Doesn't get the first down. William Thomas again on the stop.
Yeah, well, you remember Pat, Richard Dent? He's the guy that's in there now. He's the pass rushing specialist for the Eagles. He's trying to get over the guard there and get away from Eric Williams. He just gets a push up the middle, though, and he's the guy that kind of flushed old Wade Wilson out of there.
Flannery and Eric Williams on the block on Dent.
I think Dent went and lined up over Flannery instead of lining up over Eric Williams, and Eric Williams went and got him anyway.
Goins kick. Takes an Eagle bounce. The Cowboys touch it at about the 31-yard line, and it continues to go back in the Eagles' favor. Philadelphia will take over with Dallas leading 6-0. Dallas leading Philadelphia. Coaching staffs for both teams upstairs. Pat Summerall here with John Madden. Philadelphia has the ball. Rodney Peets, the quarterback. Charlie Garner is the deep back. He brings a little different pace. That's Garner. Tumbling to the outside. Picked up about 3.
You know, yesterday when we were talking to Ray Rhodes, he says the guys that he wanted to get involved early, he says, You want to get Irving Fryer, and of course they have. He has five touches. They say they want to get the ball to Charlie Garner. He's had one, just had his second right there. Kevin Turner hasn't had any, and of course Ricky Waters has had six. So those are the guys that they want to get involved in the game early. The only guy that really has is Kevin Turner.
Cowboys showing blitz. The Eagles pick it up. Rodney Pete scrambles out of bounds and is hit, and the flag goes down as Pete headed out of bounds. Hit by Tony Tolbert.
Look at Barry Switzer there. He's saying that it wasn't out of bounds. He's almost in a
unnecessary roughness. Number 92 of the defense. 15 yards. First down.
Switzer looked like he was about to cry.
That's what I was going to say. But there's Tony Tolbert, number 92. He comes off with coverage. Now now Pete is out of bounds already, and he just gives him that little push is what it was. You know, here's Fred Strickland. You watch number 55. You see, he starts in there, and he's going to get in there and get that position that really flushes Rodney Pete to the outside. Because Strickland came to the inside, now Tolbert has outside contained. And as far as the rules go, Rodney Pete was out of bounds, and Tony Tolbert did hit him.
After that penalty, the Eagles have a first down at the Cowboy 46. Fryer is the man in motion, and Pete calls a timeout.
Yeah, I think he was looking at the play clock and running out of time on the play clock.
Philadelphia has two timeouts left.
Sorry.
Late for work? Try the new Accord V6 Coupe from Honda.
Boys, check it out. Coach.
Check it out.
Dawson, nice tattoo.
You've been traded to my army.
Gonna be a while?
Ah.
Grab a Snickers.
What do you think?
Fish.
That's right, a fish.
Good morning. This is your wake-up call. And this is the Norelco Reflex Action Razor. Anything closer could be too close for comfort. Insuring over 40 million people worldwide.
Box NFL Sunday is brought to you by the 1998 Honda Accord, an Accord like no other.
Eagle first down at the Cowboy 46. Two tight ends set up. Hand off to Garner. Garner taken down by Brock Marion. Aflac trivia question time. And who is the only player to have a 1,000-yard receiving season with three different teams? 1,000 yards with three different teams. Any ideas?
Is he playing in this game? Is he on the field now as we speak?
I don't know. He probably might be somewhere.
No, on this field.
I don't think so. I could be wrong. He might be.
I think he is.
Pass is incomplete to Irving Fryer. Right now for a McDonald's game break. Let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Pat, San Francisco moving out just a bit more over New Orleans. Gary Anderson with a 36-yard field goal. That's his 12th straight this season. It's a 10-0 49er lead. Dr. Pat Summerall and John Madden.
4:43 left to play in the second quarter. 6-0 Dallas. Philadelphia ball. At the Dallas 43.
Excuse me. This is the area that the Eagles have problems with their passing game, and Rodney Peters, third and anything over 6 or 7.
They go with 4 wide receivers. Deep out of the pocket. He'll have time now. The pass is complete. To Mark Say, enough for a first down.
And Rodney Pete really bought time on that one, because Tony Tolbert went by Barrett Brooks, and he really has a sack. If you watch it up here and you watch Tolbert right here, he gets into the backfield, but Rodney Pete makes a move on him. Watch him right there. You see, he steps up, then he steps out, buys some time, and gets a first down. Rodney Pete got that first down with the move that he made on Tony Tolbert. You know, the guy that knows that the most is Tony Tolbert.
Tony Tolbert, right. Four wide receivers set up again. Pete retreats, and the blitz is coming. And the pass is picked off, I believe.
They're blowing whistles. So
Kevin Smith.
This isn't going to count with Kevin Smith to run. The interception part may count. But
maybe.
Because I do see someone spotting it. The Cowboys were, it was a first down play, and the Cowboys were in their three-man line.
Yep.
And they had Bill Bates in there, so they were using a form of a nickel defense on fourth down. You see the three defensive linemen. There's Bill Bates coming in the middle. In fact, they bring three defensive backs on that play.
No interception. No interception. They're saying he trapped it now. I think that's an interception. I think that's an interception.
Kevin Smith's hands were under that ball. I think it hit his hands under the ball.
Two tight ends set up. Charlie Garner picking his way gets very little. That Aflac trivia question. John's question was, is he in this game the only player to have 1,000-yard receiving seasons with three different teams? And I think he is. And I think that might be Irving Fryer.
Yep.
With the Patriots, the Dolphins, and the Eagles.
And a guy who, you know, they talk about, you know, players that are changes, and they're changing their imaging and their image and so on. And Irving Fryer is a guy that not only changed his image, but he really turned his entire life around.
And he lives the changes. Here's Pete back to throw. Firing deep, incomplete. Intended for Timpson.
I think Michael Timpson could have had something there, because there wasn't a free safety there. But Rodney Pete, you see, is going to get pressured. He doesn't get a chance to really step up, although he got hit after he threw that ball. But that's the time that you want to throw. Anytime there's no one in the middle, if you can just wait, and you just see that if we stop it here, and you can see that there's no one in this area right here, now you can take and you can lead that ball. That's the perfect time to have that call play. That play call.
Chris Bonial on the field now. Missed his only field goal attempt today from 52 yards away. This one will be 47. He was well short from 52. He, of course, the Dallas kicker last year. High snap. Bonio's kick won't get there.
Boy, Eagle kicking has been ugly in this first
it
half.
It really has. The specialists don't kick like specialists.
In this great world, I go just where I please.
Right now, all Goodyear tires are on sale at Sears, like Eagles and Wranglers.
And I say, roll like a wheel, it's time to roll.
All Goodyear tires on sale through November 5th.
Tell us the truth, Dr. Trank. Which battery will last over 30% longer in these digital cameras?
Duracell or Energizer? Energizer.
Well, lucky bunny.
.257 left to play in the first half. 6-0 Dallas. Wade Wilson, the Dallas quarterback. Aikman was taken to the locker room. Wilson's down. Blitz got him. Mamula and Rhett Hall. That wasn't a blitz.
Yeah, I think Rhett Hall was the first guy in there. Here, Mamula's going to come from out here. Rhett Hall gets the pressure straight up the middle. See, Mamula's outside. Red Hall right there. They didn't block Red Hall.
They were blitzing.
Yeah, and what happens is they let Red Hall go, and I think Herschel Walker was supposed to pick him up, and Red Hall ran right by Herschel Walker.
Four straight games, Red Hall has had a sack. Second down and very long. Wade Wilson pitches back to Emmitt Smith. Smith gets some of it back. Gets outside the 40. Red Hall made the stop.
Red Hall's from Live Oak High School in Morgan Hill, California.
How do you know that?
No, I just thought I'd throw that in there. You wonder where guys come from and went to Gavilan Junior College and went to the University of California and played for the 49ers. All about Red Hall.
Two minutes left in the first half.
Presenting the play that made the difference. Brought to you by Wendy's, where freshness is what makes the difference. In week five against the Chargers, the Ravens took wing and a 3-point second half lead. Could the lightning bolt strike for a comeback win? Stay tuned.
Dave Thomas is looking for people who haven't tried Wendy's fresh stuffed pitas.
May I approach the bench, Your Honor?
Please.
According to our records, you haven't tried our new pitas.
I guess I'm guilty.
Well, there's four to choose from. My favorite is the chicken Caesar.
I'll take that into consideration.
All four of Wendy's delicious pitas are stuffed full of crisp vegetables, and we have two with tender chunks of chicken breast.
These are great.
Say, Judge, you know Charlie Small.
I do. He should be back in 2 to 3.
Don't be the last one to try them.
On the final play of the third quarter, San Diego went deep and came away with the game's final score.
Touchdown, San Diego!
A terrific toss and catch. And week five's most pivotal moment.
Listen, Charlie, there's no way that my client is going to go for something like this. And what is with this paragraph?
Listen, Charlie, you're killing me here.
You've been through this a million times, Charlie.
Yeah.
The Civic Sedan from Honda.
No.
What more do you need?
Charlie, I gotta go. Somebody's here.
Halloween night, Frank Black confronts a messenger from hell.
The time is near. There's no way he can lose.
An all-new Millennium, Friday at 9, 8 Central.
Okay. Dallas 6, Philadelphia nothing. 2 minutes left before halftime. Cowboys have the ball third and about 7 at their own 42. We're still waiting for information on Troy Aikman. The only thing we have is that he has a strained neck. Here comes the Eagle blitz against Wade Wilson, who's going deep. Flag on the play. The pass is caught by Michael Irvin. But there was a penalty marker on the play. Wilson saw the blitz coming and lofted it down to Irvin.
Face mask, number 59 of the defense. 5 yards from
Mike Mamula.
So this is going to count right here.
Yep.
Because it's against Mamula and the Eagles anyway. Now Michael Irvin makes a heck of a move and then makes a heck of a catch holding on to that thing.
First down.
There's a penalty right there, and Mike Mamula, he grabbed Wade Wilson's face mask after he threw the ball, but that was a heck of a throw by Wade Wilson.
It was
a heck of a catch by Michael Irvin. And then that's why, you know, the receivers always have to work on hands so that they have strong hands to hold on to the ball. Here's Mamula. He takes an inside move here. And he's going to reach up. You see, and he just grabs with his left hand there as he goes by. But the ball was gone.
First down, Dallas, the handoff to Emmitt Smith, and Emmitt gets down to about the 21-yard line. They're well within field goal range. Hollis Thomas made the stop. They'd like to get more than a field goal, obviously.
Yeah, I'm not a coach anymore, but the one thing that I think that Emmitt Smith has to do is keep his feet moving longer. I think he stopped his feet too soon now.
Who are these people? They go to the strangest places, work in the tightest quarters, and gladly keep the oddest hours. Who are they? Forever probing and prodding, digging, exploring. Who are these people? They are Texaco. And what they do is find the energy the world needs to keep on running. Texaco, a world of energy.
Back at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, Pat Summerall with John Madden. 6-0 Dallas leads, 2nd and 6 for the Cowboys at the Eagles 22-yard line.
Yeah, an interesting thing. The Eagles just took out Mike Mamula.
Johnson was the man in motion. That's Emmitt Smith. Emmitt Smith. About 3 yards. Word we just received is that Troy Aikman is still in uniform, is in the locker room. Doctors are talking with him. Possible concussion they're talking about. Possible. Still has the neck strain that we told you about earlier, but possible concussion. May or may not be back. I suppose it depends on whether or not he has a concussion.
And I think they probably decided they're going to take the time at least through halftime to determine what they're going to do with Troy Aikman for right. The second half.
Wade Wilson, meanwhile, has done a good job. Lost it deep. No flag this time. Benson back with Aikman.
That has been a heck of a physical matchup there. Barry Switzer's asking for it. He thinks that Troy Benson is getting too physical out there with Michael Irvin, but that's the way they're letting him play today.
Yep.
You see, he just took him and put his right hand up there, and he's looking back, and he just rolled him right out of bounds. And the key thing there, you watch Barry Switzer there. He wants the flag. He wants the flag. He wants the flag. But the key thing was that Troy Benson looked back at the ball.
Michael Irvin limping off the field a bit.
Yeah, well, Troy Benson on that play rode him right out of bounds. Watch him. See, Michael Irvin didn't get physical at all. Troy Benson is just riding him with his head and his arm right out of bounds, and it looked like he may have tripped over the pylon.
He stepped on his foot.
Well, that's the way a physical corner plays against a physical receiver.
Coming up on the Dockers Khakis halftime report, we'll bring you scores and highlights from around the league. Also, our Fox Sports ticker will have up to the second stat. That's all coming up on the Dockers Khakis halftime report. Timeout. This one by Dallas. They have one left.
You know, one thing that Ray Rhodes does, he does a heck of a job motivating his teams and, you know, just generally. And then specifically, motivating a corner to do a job. You know, it had been Bobby Taylor, and today he has motivated Troy Benson to be physical against Michael Irvin.
Cunningham from 35 yards out. Johnson the holder. Cunningham is true again. 9-0. Dallas leads. It's the final countdown to the season premiere of The X-Files. And unless you see this episode, you won't be ready 1 week from tonight for the television event of the year, The X-Files season's premiere. The countdown continues tonight at 9, 8 Central, here on Fox.
And we see Michael Irvin talking to the official over there, and again, it's talking about that physicalness, you know. What can he do? And if he can do that, then what can I do? I think he's laughing at that, where the guy, you know, said, okay, it's okay to be physical.
Michael Irvin's going to do whatever it takes.
Yeah, and then he's going and telling Deion Sanders, hey, the official just told me you can do this, so you do what Troy Vincent's been doing to me.
Right. 9-0, Dallas lead.
But as far as a cover corner, Deion Sanders doesn't need a lot of, no. Hey, you know what you have to do. He knows what he has to do.
Deuce Staley back deep for the Eagles. Toby going to set to kick it off. Staley is going to field it at about the 1. Upended. The ball loose. The ball is loose. And Dallas saying, we got it.
And the officials are pointing to the ground. That means he was down. What they're saying is that he was down before the ball came out. When the official comes up and points to the ground, he's saying no fumble.
Looks like Deuce Staley hits the ground.
Yeah, I mean, he has the ball when he hits the ground, and the ground can't cause a fumble, and that's what that official was doing. He called it right now. He came up, and he was pointing to the ground. Joe Avezzano doesn't buy it, but the official did come running up, pointing to the ground all the way.
It was not for sale, whether he bought it or not. Short pass to Ricky Waters. Nothing doing there that's going to...
Hey, that's one thing
too much.
The defense of the Cowboys, the thing they talked about doing was keeping Ricky Waters under control, and they sure have done that this first half.
Yep. Dave Campbell has done a remarkable job with this Dallas defense. I mean, they've changed their whole philosophy. There's Dave Campbell. Changed their whole philosophy from 2 years ago.
Yeah,
and they're still very effective.
And he's lost some great players.
Yeah.
I mean, you take a Charles Haley out of there. Charles Haley was one of the great pass rushers. You take a Leon Lett not playing, Darren Woodson not playing today. And he's had a go from he doesn't have a dominant pass rusher now. So, of course, the Cowboys have gone to a lot more blitzing.
Here's Rodney Pete back to throw. Steps up to the pocket, still running in the pocket, gets it outside to Ricky Waters, who steps off enough yardage to get a first down.
And then all that buys is one more play anyway. I think this is just going to be one that you have to heave it deep and hope for pass interference, because you know that the game or the half cannot end on a defensive penalty.
9-0. I don't know if he got enough for a first down before he stepped out of bounds or not.
No, there's still one more play anyway.
Yep.
They're still going to just throw it up anyway. And again, he can't throw it far enough to get into the end zone, so he has to hope for a defensive penalty.
When you
look at some of the things they've done on offense and some of the things their punter and kicker have done, it's been a ugly first half for the Eagles.
That's the end of the first half with the score. Dallas 9, Philadelphia nothing. Fox NFL Sunday will continue with the Dockers Khakis halftime report after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. There is Troy Aikman out of football uniform now, back with no shoulder pads. He has a mild concussion. Will not be back. They don't want to take a chance on him. This is how it all happened. This is where he got hit. And watch the hit to the head that came right there from Jimmy Jones. And this was after he made it over to the sideline. That's on the way to the locker room. Now he is back on the sideline, out of football uniform. Will not be back.
You know, in fact, he still looks a little woozy, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Because when Jimmy Jones hit him, it was a helmet-to-helmet collision, and his head really did snap back. I think it's more of the concussion than it is the neck. I think Michael Irvin, Pat, and watching him, I think he's still fired up over what Troy Vincent did to him on that play, because he had a chance to get a touchdown. I mean, he was going for a shot at the end zone. It was in that red zone area. He was going down there, and Troy Vincent was a lot more physical on him than he was on Troy Vincent. In fact, he just out-physicaled him right off the field.
That doesn't happen very often when he gets out physical.
No, and you know, I mean, his point is right, too, that, you know, that's illegal. I mean, what Troy Vincent, you can touch him in the first 5 yards, and after that, you can't make contact with him. You can't make contact when the ball is in the air.
They're still trying to make that point.
But, you know, but they've been letting, I mean, officials this year have let receivers and defensive backs get away with a lot more than they have in years past.
They call it snuggling.
Well, you know that, you know that's bad when they even have a word for it.
Yeah. Bouncing to Deuce Staley. Took off, he left the ball. Staley. Down at about about the 16-yard line. Again, the special teams for Dallas do their job, and the Eagles special teams have their problems.
And the Eagles special teams have their problems in every area. It's not only covering, but it's returning, and it's punting, and it's kicking, and everything. You look at here, they've missed two field goals. Hutton's punting average is 17 yards, and he's had one block.
Yeah.
They're allowed a 47-yard kickoff return.
Eagles ball at their own 15. Two tight ends, and Philadelphia sends Ricky Waters punting out to about the 21-yard line.
You know, Ricky Waters in the first half had six carries for 12 yards. So they, you know, they have to stop Ricky Waters. That's what the Cowboys felt, and
that's what they've done.
They did it the first half, and conversely, the Eagles have to get Ricky Waters going, and they're just taking him out on second down. He doesn't like that.
Get him going on the bench.
But they do have to get something going offensively. I mean, they've tried him, and that hasn't worked.
Second and five, that's Fryer moving in motion to his left. And Rodney Pete back to throw it. Swings it outside to Kevin Turner. That was deflected.
Well, the fans are booing. I mean, what they want to see, in Rodney Pete or in the passing game here, if you're going to pass the ball, throw it down the field. You know, we try and run. We get stuffed in the run. And now if we're going to pass, let's get it to Irving Fryer. You know, let's get it out there and get it down or up the field or whatever that's called. You know, let's use Michael Timpson. Let's use Irving Fryer. Let's do those kind of things instead of throwing little loop passes to Kevin Turner.
In the event you might have just joined us, it's been raining steadily since the first of the game. Here comes a Dallas blitz. Offsides against Dallas, I'm sure. Kevin Turner, the intended receiver.
And the Cowboys have something going with that blitz, because in the first half, Rodney Pete against the blitz was just one out of seven.
Charlie Williams, I believe, was offside from the corner. Number 42.
Offside. Number 42 of the defense. 5 yards. It will be just short of the first down. Repeat third down.
You heard him, Jerry Austin, the referee, say, here's the offside violation.
Yeah, you see, Charlie Williams is trying to time it up, and you want to come across there just as the ball is snapped, and he took a step just before the ball was snapped.
Third about a half a yard.
But again, the Cowboys have had great success against their pass with their blitz package.
For the first down. Rodney Pete replaced Ty Detmer as the starter a week ago. And his wife had twins last week. He went to California, came back, very little sleep. And Ray Rhodes said when he first got back, it showed, but he shook it off in a day's time.
Yeah, he said he wasn't very sharp on Wednesday, but he came back on Thursday, was very sharp. In fact, he said in all their passing drills, not one ball hit the ground.
Waters outside the 30, stopped by Tony Tolbert.
I'll tell you this defensive line of the Cowboys is really stuffing up that middle. I mean, Tolbert there, Casillas, Antonio Anderson, and then Fred Strickland in the middle. They aren't really getting much in there all day. I mean, you know they've tried it. They've tried to hit that middle. There's Chad Hennings, who, you know, will be back there when that groin heals up. But Ricky Waters has tried to hit that middle, and there hasn't been anything there all day.
That's nothing. Here's Pete back to throw. Intended for Irving Fryer. Behind him again. Flag on the play.
Yep, and it's right back in the area where Rodney Pete was knocked down. Like you say, Pat, the
personal foul. Roughing the passer. Number 96 of the defense. 15 yards, automatic first down.
Antonio Anderson.
Antonio Anderson is the rookie defensive tackle we're talking about that's been stuffing up that middle. And you see that Rodney Pete throws the ball, and Antonio Anderson just comes and hits him. But he's gonna be coming right there. He kind of hit him with his helmet, but doesn't make any difference. It was a hit in the helmet or the crown or whatever. He hit him after he threw the ball.
Two tight ends set up for the Eagles. First down, Eagles. They're on 47. This is Waters again. Crosses across the insignia into Cowboy territory. Yesterday, we spoke to Rodney Pete about the birth of those twins, Rodney Jackson and Ryan Elizabeth.
It was the most amazing experience that I've ever gone through. You know, I think that, you know, anytime you become a father, it's a great time in your life. And for me, people would tell me what it's like, you know, and say, be ready for this, be ready for that, and this is what it's going to be like. And you say, yeah, I understand that. But you never really actually feel it or know it until you actually go through it.
That's Ricky Waters bouncing his way again to the 45, stopped by Shante Carver.
Yeah, I'm not an expert in that area, but, you know, congratulations to the mother and the father. But, you know, the thing that on that birth announcement that kind of surprised me was the short time between the deliveries. Watch, here's 9:28 was Rodney Jackson, and then Ryan Elizabeth was 9:30. That's only 2 minutes. You know, as I figured out, and I always thought it was like more like 20 minutes or a half hour between.
Well, like you said, you're not an expert.
No, I'm not a doctor.
In that area.
I've never been involved in any parts of that area, but
Pete,
2 minutes
high.
Didn't seem like a very long time.
High and behind Irving Fryer.
Rodney Pete's been throwing behind, as we said, all day. It was something that sometimes a quarterback will do that and you know, just get out of it. I think this one here was, you know, partly deflected. I mean, that was Fred Strickland. You see Fred Strickland got up there and jumped up and knocked that one off. But usually they make an adjustment as the game goes on. Rodney Pete hasn't made an adjustment as the game has gone on.
Hutton back to punt. High kick. Sanders going to let it bounce. Eagles knock it back to about the 5. And that's where it'll be down.
There is an Eagle special teams play, and the fans are cheering now.
Ray Farmer knocked it backwards.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Isuzu, builders of the completely reinvented 1998 Isuzu Rodeo. Isuzu, go farther. By Pizza Hut. Enjoy today's game with the Edge Pizza, new from Pizza Hut. 16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge? And by HBO. It's not TV, it's HBO.
Dallas ball at their own 6. 11-10 left in the third quarter. Dallas leading 9-0. Miller was the man in motion. Emmett Smith gets the carry. And Emmett dragging tacklers out to about the 19.
Yeah,
Michael
that looked,
Zordich.
Now, that looked like the old Emmett Smith. Two things he did. One was the cutback. He started to the right, cut back to the left. And the other thing is, at the first contact, he kept his feet moving.
Dragging tacklers.
And you're just going to watch. He's going to start to the right here. See him start to the right, and then bring it right back here. Now watch when that first tackler comes right there. He just keeps those feet moving and just runs right through it. And I think that if he keeps his feet moving, he can run more through more tackles.
Here's Emmett Smith again. For about 3, stopped by William Thomas.
You want to get in there behind big Eric Williams some, too, because that's still the strength of this, you know, Cowboy offensive line is
Emmett,
still Larry Allen and Eric Williams.
Emmett Smith still down. Sherman Williams already has entered. Aikman is already gone, and Emmett is down.
Freedom on the Field, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. With fares so low, you have the freedom to fly. The quarterback, confident leader of the offense. With supreme grace and dexterity, he guides his team down the field. With passes quick and sure, his receivers know that if they execute the play, the ball will be waiting for them. And if they do not, the quarterback will execute for them.
What do you get when you fly Southwest Airlines? Fun fares.
Well, you've waited so long for a fare to get so nice and low now.
Now you really should fly.
Ooh.
Light up the night. Southwest Airlines fun fares are so low. Want to see that again? Now you can fly just for the fun of it.
The world is filled with obstacles, boundaries, and limits. Ignore them. Introducing the completely reinvented 205 horsepower Isuzu Rodeo. Billy's taking the plunge.
Will you marry me?
And Taylor.
Nobody messes with me twice.
He's taking a fall on an all-new Melrose Place. Monday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Emmett Smith standing over on the sideline. Let's see if we can figure out what happened.
I think if you just watch his head right in there, you just see that as it goes down, he gets snapped back. You see, he gets bent over. In fact, he's showing the trainers on the sideline exactly what it was. It wasn't a leg thing. It was just he got his head just bent forward.
So Sherman Williams is the running back now. Wade Wilson is the quarterback. Wilson intended for Anthony Miller, incomplete.
You know, it's going to be interesting how Wade Wilson's timing is with Anthony Miller, because for one reason or another, Troy Aikman has never gotten it down with him. And, you know, Troy Aikman's timing with Michael Irvin, you know, has been so good and so strong. And, you know, it's never been good with Anthony Miller. And you wonder how Wade Wilson's is going to be. We see Emmett Smith is back in the lineup.
Our word is that Emmett has a bruised rib, but he's back in the game.
You can bend your head and hurt your rib.
Wilson. Flag on the play. Stepford Williams, I believe, was the intended receiver. Willie Clark was the defender.
And they're going to call it on Willie Clark, I think, because Willie Clark made one mistake there. He threw his hands out like he didn't do something. Isn't that usually a sign of guilt? Watch Willie Clark here. He's number 25 on Stepford Williams. You see, and he's going to ride him there. And again, he had that hand in there. Now watch him put his hands up in the air like he didn't do anything. Well, it happened after that. But he goes by and says, right
me?
There.
Me? Not me.
That sign there, when the hands are extended, palms out and up, it's a sign of guilt.
First and 10. Cowboys have moved it out to their 26. Emmett Smith, flag on the play in front of Emmett.
I'll tell you, George Hageman got a good block on that one. He's the guy that got his guy and then put him down and really created a hole for Emmett Smith.
Holding, number 88 of the offense.
Holding call against Michael Irvin. You know, it's kind of ironic that both the offensive tackles for the Cowboys are from the Philadelphia area. Hageman's from Camden, New Jersey, just across the river. And Eric Williams is from South Philadelphia.
And watch what Michael Irvin is doing. You see, we talked about how physical everything is with he and Troy Vincent. Looks like they both had a hold of each other. In fact, at the end of that play, it was Troy Vincent who had a hold of Michael Irvin. But on a running play, you can do that. Remember, there is a difference that a defender can play off a wide receiver on a running play. It's on the pass play they can't hit him after 5 yards or when the ball's in the air.
First and about 14 yards. Wade Wilson to Herschel Walker. Walker gets to the 30. James Willis made the stop. Philadelphia, one of the teams that Herschel Walker's played for.
And he was disappointed when he was let go. In fact, yep. when the Eagles brought in Ricky Waters and they brought in Kevin Turner, Ray Rhodes was saying we had no cap room. Herschel Walker thought that they really just kind of brushed him off and let him go and didn't appreciate everything that he had done while he was here in Philadelphia.
He didn't care for the way it was handled. Nicky Sualua is the running back, the blocking back, and Emmitt Smith is the running back. Emmitt close to midfield. That should put him about 100 yards. Brian Dawkins made the stop.
And again, Sualua gets in and out of the hole on this one. See, you're going to start off here. Here's Emmitt Smith. He's going to run to the right here. Sualua makes the thing now, and now he can just cut off that. See, because the first time we saw Sualua, he waited a while before he got into the hole. But here's Larry Allen taking his guy, Eric Williams taking his guy, Sualua getting his guy.
Yep.
But the guy that really got his guy was Larry Allen. He got his guy to the ground.
Emmitt at the line of scrimmage this time. Hageman involved in a little shoving match with William Thomas.
Hageman's playing pretty well. They were worried about Hageman today, and that's why they were moving Larry Allen over there on third down. But Hageman's not playing poorly over there.
We were at the Cowboys Hotel last night meeting with some of the players, and I ran into George Hageman in the hall. And there's no room to go by on either side.
What did you do, slither?
I went the other way. I'm not good at slithering. Wilson goes down. William Thomas led the charge. Hollis Thomas also on the scene.
You know, everyone is talking about, you know, they want Sherman Williams, they want this and that. But you have to remember, when you put a back in there, that back not only has to be able to run the ball, but he has to be able to pass protect. Because if you get a running back in there that can't pass protect, you're going to keep him in, and you can formulate a blitz that makes him stay in there, and he has to block. Now, Sherman Williams on that play was not very, very good.
He could have been called for holding very easily.
He could have been called for anything, and he's probably being called everything on the sideline.
Third and 18. Three wide receivers. Wade Wilson calls a timeout. That's Dallas' first one they've taken, so they have two left. Wade Wilson's done a good job. He seems very composed.
Searching for something better. When you're looking for a change, every once in a while, you come across a Gossamer Bay. Capture something better.
Hey, NFL fans, do us a favor, please. Put something on. Like officially licensed NFL merchandise at Goodyear. Right now, get some of Goodyear's best selected tires like AquaTread, Eagles, and Wranglers. And get $50 or $75 good towards officially licensed NFL merchandise at participating Goodyear retailers. Call 1-800-GOODYEAR for the retailer nearest you. Great Goodyear treads, incredible NFL treads. Boom, nice fashion statement, fella.
Or three quarters.
10 millimeter.
My favorite.
The all-new Mazda truck. Pure truck.
Fox presents the biggest love story of our time. An all-new Ally McBeal, Monday after Melrose Place.
Troy Aikman in the baseball cap under the hood. Over on the sideline, slight concussion. They don't want to take a chance on him coming back. He's in street clothes. Wade Wilson, in the meantime, has the job. Three wide receivers, third and long. Wilson, incomplete. Through the arm.
Boy, running backs have dropped more passes today, haven't they? I mean, you know, we know Herschel Walker did that, and now we see Emmitt Smith did that, and Sherman Williams did that. Kevin Turner did that. Ricky Waters did that. I don't know if it's the, you know, that those gloves get wet because it's been raining, and they're supposed to be tackified gloves, and if they get wet and the ball just slides through or what, but the running backs have had a tough time catching the football today.
Mark Say back to receive the punt. Say gets away from one man, away from another, and Mark Say's got some room. At midfield almost. Mark Say. The Eagles special teams have finally contributed.
And Mark Say made the first move because Billy Davis was down there right on him, and Mark Say made Billy Davis miss.
9-0 Dallas.
Three-quarters.
10 millimeter.
My favorite.
The all-new Mazda truck. Pure truck.
This dish is gonna change my life.
I like you better already. Turn it on, turn it on.
And now, I give you...
Game time.
Heidi. Heidi?
They said it was on satellite TV.
It's on DirecTV. DirecTV?
You don't have DirecTV. You got Heidi.
Only DirecTV delivers more sports than any other mini dish system. If you don't have it, you're gonna get it.
If you squint, you kind of look like John Elway.
DirecTV, satellite TV at its best.
Shuffling papers all day long requires concentration. Someone hold my calls. I'm on a Big Mac vacation.
It's a money day, McDonald's.
If it were a guy's world, this would be your 9-to-5. And you'd always be cool. But in the real world, guys sweat 40% more than women. Guys need the protection of Speed Stick antiperspirant. Speed Stick, protection just for the guys.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Mazda. Come see what happens when a car company has more engineers and fewer accountants. Mazda.
Are you frightened? 9-0.
Watch this. Here's Billy Davis. This is a heck of a play. I mean, he beats a double team, gets down there, and now Mark Say just dips that shoulder underneath him, and by making Billy Davis miss, he came up with about 50 more yards.
And it's first and 10, the Eagles. And the handoff is to Charlie Garner. And Garner, he can make things happen, and finally Brock Marion takes him out of bounds. All the way down at the Cowboy 27-yard line.
Well, that's the change of pace that they're talking about, and that's what Charlie Garner is. Ricky Waters is their running back. Charlie Garner is their change of pace, and anytime Ray Rhodes wants to change that pace, he puts Charlie Garner in there, and then after every game, he'll say that he should have done it more and more, because most of the time when he does it, it works.
25 yards worth that time. This is Ricky Waters. Waters to the 20, to the 18. Stoutmeyer made the stop.
Now Ricky says he wants some of that adulation that Charlie Gardner's getting. He's giving me some of that too. So sometimes you know, one guy will motivate another guy when they're going, and Ricky Waters isn't getting much going. First half he had 6 carries for 12 yards, and Charlie Gardner gives him a little change of pace, and then they can open up some holes here.
Second and 2. Rodney Peete changing the play, changing the backs of Peete to Michael Simpson, close to the 12-yard line, and an Eagle first down. Kevin Smith made the stop.
Yeah, and this was an audible here. We see Timpson is just going to come up, and he's just going to run it out here. So he's just going to stop, then slide to the outside. He knew where the first down marker was, and Rodney Peete saw the corners of the Cowboys playing off and audibilized to that play.
Waters is deep. Waters gets the handoff. Not much. That run by Charlie Garner, 25 yards, was the longest run allowed by the Cowboys this year.
You know, Rodney Pete was saying yesterday how important Charlie Garner is, and how sometimes when the coaches forget about it, he'll remind them. You know, he said, give me a little Charlie Garner. Let's go a little Charlie Garner. Because sometimes you do. I mean, you get stuck in a game, and if a guy's out of sight, you just forget about him.
Garner is the lone setback. Pete again.
This is another audible.
Yep. Behind Irving Fryer. He made that remarkable catch in the first quarter.
And again, this is an adjustment that we talked about earlier that Rodney Pete hasn't made this whole game. He's been throwing behind his receivers all day, and he throws another one behind Irving Fryer.
That was an automatic, an audible.
Yeah, he said last week he called 15 audibles or 15 checks, and usually it's only three or four, but with all the blitzing today, the quarterback has to audibleize a lot more.
Two tight ends. Pete. This time the pass is dropped by Timpson. And a flag on the play.
And that's going to be against the Eagles, Pat. That's a holding penalty against the Eagles. It'll be interesting what the Cowboys do with it. I think they would turn down. Barry Switzer is saying
they turn it down.
On the offense. Penalty is declined. Fourth down.
That's Barrett Brooks. Because it's an incomplete pass, I think. And it is third down. You see, but even though there is a penalty, this is another pass that is behind the receiver. You see, Timpson has to stop and then kind of come back. So
he didn't quite get stopped.
Rodney Pete, whatever it is, sure doesn't have his timing down and hasn't gotten it during this game.
Bonio from 29 yards. This time he's missed twice from close to 50. This one's good. And the Eagles finally get on the scoreboard. Bonio applauds his efforts. 9-3.
At BASF, we don't make the mattress, we make it softer. We don't make the boots, we make them drier. We don't make the house, we make it livelier. We don't make the snowboard, we make it stronger. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Ship your package in 2 days with FedEx. And you'll run into 7 different price zones.
Ship your package in 2 days with UPS. And you'll run into 7 different price zones.
Ship your package in 2 to 3 days with Priority Mail. And there's just one price zone.
So, what's your priority? Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service.
Rent-a-car, because our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow!
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Mr. Dave Thomas?
May I approach the bench, Your Honor? According to our records, you haven't tried our new pitas.
I guess I'm guilty.
Come try Wendy's delicious fresh stuffed pitas today.
These are great.
You know Charlie Small?
I do. He should be back in 2 to 3.
Nicholson, Pfeiffer. When the full moon rises, the beast will hunt.
Don't look so scared.
Wolf, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Tonight, Fox kicks off a week of Halloween screams with the Simpsons Scare-a-thon. A brand new Halloween special plus 2 classic episodes. Then Hank makes a deal with the devil on a brand new King of the Hill. It all starts tonight at 7, 6 Central on Fox. Bonio set to kick off. Walker and Marion back deep for the Cowboys. Herschel Walker to the 30, just outside.
Yeah, that's one thing. The Cowboys aren't as good as they were when they were a real good team, but the thing that they're having a problem with this year is putting anyone away. And, you go back to that red zone and then settling for field goals, and then they leave an opponent in the game, and then at the end of the game, that opponent, even though they're not as good as the Cowboys are, can come back and steal or win a game from them.
First and 10, Nicky Sualoa. The deep back in front of Emmitt Smith, and he's tackled behind the line of scrimmage by Rhett Hall. And right now for a McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Pat, Gary Anderson booting his 14th consecutive field goal this season. That makes it 16-0. New Orleans threatening to be shut out for the second consecutive game. Of course, next week it'll be Dallas and San Francisco. Back to Pat and John.
And next week, Pat and John will be in San Francisco.
Yeah, in fact, John will be leaving for San Francisco right after this game. I don't know if I can get through on 80, though, with that snowstorm in Colorado I saw last night.
Well, the Broncos had trouble getting out. Wilson's pass out to Emmitt Smith. And Emmitt gets very little.
If there's one play that hasn't worked all day, in fact, I think by now I would stop using it, is it's a back on the flat or a loop. I mean, both teams have tried it. The Cowboys have tried it to Emmitt Smith. They've tried it to Herschel Walker. It doesn't work.
Both teams have had trouble catching it.
Yeah, and then if they do catch it, there's about eight guys waiting for them when they catch it. So I think they either ought to run the ball or throw the ball down the field. But that little loop to the back is not one of the things that works.
Larry Allen over at left tackle again.
Against Richard Dent this time.
Stafford Williams makes the reception, not nearly enough for a first down.
You see,
Richard Dent disappeared.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, he had a little help from Bjornsson right here. Here's Eric Allen, Larry Allen, and here's Richard Dent. But watch Bjornsson. He's going to wait right there. Doink. He's the guy that redirects him. Larry Allen, I don't know that needs any help, but
no.
The Cowboys have been putting him at left tackle on passing downs and also giving him some help.
Mark Say back deep for the Eagles. He'll be going to kick it. Off the side of his foot, not very good kick. Midfield, and the Cowboys down it right there. A flag on the play. Flag on the play.
There's another flag. There's two hats and two flags. We got all kinds of stuff.
And
all kinds
raining.
Of stuff. Yeah.
It's raining.
Well, you know, anytime you see the hat, that means someone went out of bounds. It'll be against the Cowboys.
You go out of bounds, you can't be the first one to touch the ball. 17 yards is the net on the punt.
Number 42 was the first to go out of bounds and come back in and touch the ball. That's illegal touching. That penalty is declined. First down, Philadelphia.
See, what happens is when a guy goes out of bounds, then he can't come in. Now, he's out of bounds right now. Now, it's all right for him to come back in, but he can't come back in and be the first guy to touch the ball. See, he's okay until right there. When he touched the ball, that's the illegality.
He can make a tackle, but he can't touch the ball.
Or he can be the second guy or the third guy or the fifth guy or the 13th guy to catch the ball, but he can't be the first guy to touch the ball after he's been out of bounds.
Ricky Waters, and Waters stays on his feet down inside the 40 to about the Cowboy 37. Broderick Thomas took him out of bounds.
That's what we were talking about earlier. Running back has to keep his feet moving. No matter what happens, just keep your feet moving, and then you can take that step and go to the outside. Ricky Waters is right here. He's going to start to the left. He's going to start in that off tackle hole. Right there, there's nothing there, but he keeps his feet moving, and then he gets a bounce out. Because there was no force on that outside.
First and 10, Philadelphia. He gets to Waters, and Waters straight ahead stays on his feet inside the 30, the 29.
They finally got something in there. You know, they've been running that inside. They've been running inside. And finally, they got in behind Ian Beckles. Watch him. He's all excited. Here's Ian Beckles right here. He's the right guard. Now, watch how. Watch, he gets a block there, turns his guy Casillas and knocks him down,
yep.
And that's the block that finally opened up a hole in the middle for the Eagles.
8 yard gain, second and two. Waters has the first. first down and fights his way down to the 21-yard line.
Look at Ian Beckles there. He's going crazy. You don't see guards go like that. You know, it's usually the running backs that do it, but now we got a guard. He's getting excited. Number 62 there. He's jumping all over the place after those blocks.
And that's the end of the third quarter with the score. Dallas 9, Eagles 3, and Fox NFL Sunday will continue after these messages and a word from your local Fox station. 9-3, the Cowboys leading. Wade Wilson has played since Troy Aikman went out with what's been called a mild concussion and a neck strain. Here's Ricky Waters. Waters inside the 20 to about the 18.
It's funny, in this third quarter, the Eagles finally got their running game going. They've had over 85 yards now just in that third quarter. Ricky Waters ran 9 times for 56 yards. Garner 1 for 25 and Pete 1 for 3. So something that they didn't have going, especially that run in the middle,
yep.
they finally have an opening there, and they're starting to take command in that area.
Second and 6. Waters again. Hit behind the line of scrimmage by Antonio Anderson, who dragged him down finally.
That was Ricky Waters' fault. He has to get to the line of scrimmage quicker than that. He was taking it easy getting to the line of scrimmage. And you see, he just let that happen. See, he's waiting back there for something to happen. And if you wait for something to happen, the thing that's going to happen is Antonio Anderson's going to get penetration.
It's going to happen to you.
Yeah. I mean, you have to get in and get out of there. You can't spend a lot of time in your own backfield.
Waters is out. Garner's in. Down as he tried to step up in the pocket. It's Broderick Thomas. And the Eagles put their field goal unit on the field.
You know, sometimes Rodney Pete is lucky that he doesn't fumble these things, because watch where he carries the ball as he steps up. You see how it's down there? That ball is down there ready to be knocked out.
Yep.
Broderick Thomas got the sack, but I think he was going for the football.
Bonio with Hutton holding. And every one of the snaps has been sort of high. That one's high. Flag on the play. Bonio's kick is good. 37 yards out for the flag on the play. Do you take those points off the board?
No, I would never take them off, because it's not enough for a first down. It would still leave you about 4th and 3 if it's a 5-yard penalty.
Offside, number 56 of the defense. Penalty is declined. Field goal's good.
They agree with you.
Yeah, you have to do that.
So that makes it 9-6. Dallas lead is 3.
You haven't found one like it before, because we've never built one like it before. Introducing a new kind of LS400. You've never felt so connected to a car.
There's the smell. William, wide open. Oh, he blew it.
Here come the team doctors.
Are you hurt?
Yeah, I'm hurt. The people boo. Hurts my feelings.
Gonna be a while? Grab a Snickers.
Posting completion stress disorder.
Next Friday.
I know what I did and did not do.
The nightmare is real.
What are you going to do? You're going to shoot me twice?
Richard Gere. Red Corner. Rated R. October 31st everywhere.
Hey, she says nice pants.
There's a nice boy.
Dockers, khakis.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Lexus and the new LS400. When was the last time you felt so connected to a car? By Miller Lite, now official beer sponsor of the NFL. and by Visa, the official card of the NFL. It's everywhere you want to be.
Back at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, 9-6. The Eagles set to kick it off. Walker and Brock Marion back deep in the Dallas. High short kick. It'll be handled by Walker. Herschel Walker. Midfield and Moore. Herschel Walker to the 34-yard line of Philadelphia. Michael Zordich finally knocked him out of bounds.
And that was the thing Ray Rhodes talked about yesterday. Yep. He said it's not so much their offense or so much their defense. The thing that worries them most is their special teams. He talked about Herschel Walker on the kickoff return and Deion Sanders on the punt return.
And Herschel just hurt him.
Well, he said he was going to try an angle kick. You know, in other words, kick the ball off and get it outside the hash marks. This ball was not only not outside the hash marks and straight down the middle, but short. And that is a very returnable ball. A short kick that is straight down the middle.
49-yard return by Walker. Here is Wade Wilson back to throw. Gets it up the middle to Anthony Miller. Miller down at the 21-yard line of Philadelphia.
One thing the Cowboys are doing now is moving their pocket. In fact, they even moved their guard. Big Nate Newton pulled out on that play. And it was the type of thing where the quarterback is going to come out. You're going to see the quarterback come out to the right, but you also see the guard come out with them to help block. You see Nate Newton come out there, a little block, so you're moving your pocket from the middle to one of the sides.
The handoff is to Emmitt Smith, and Smith inside the 10 to about the 8. Emmitt running like the Emmitt of old.
Yeah, Nate Newton blocking like the Nate Newton of old, Pat, on that one. Getting a real push. You watch this push right here. This is what creates it. This is what starts it. Watch the left guard, Nate Newton. You see that push that they get there? Hageman gets a good push, too. Hageman collapses his guy to the inside. Big Nate collapses his guy to the inside. And that collapse makes a big hole for Emmitt Smith.
First and goal at the 8. Emmitt hit behind the line of scrimmage by Red Hall. Hey. He might have lost a yard.
Yeah, Red Hall has been the MVP of this. Well, maybe Troy Vincent, too. Vincent in the secondary, but Red Hall in that front line of guy that has been rushing the passer and getting penetration on the defense. He's made some big plays today for this Philadelphia Eagles defense.
Emmitt Smith limps off and Sherman Williams replaced him. Smith has 20 carries, 112 yards. Sherman Williams, now this is a passing down and he's got to do some blocking.
Dawkins is saying that the receiver ran into him. Again, there can't be contact when the ball's in the air. But the officials are out to talk about there is who initiated the contact. And the three officials are talking. The other officials are trying to keep the players away.
Trying to keep Michael Irvin out of the conversation.
Yeah. Now Big Nate's coming and going to have a little discussion.
A little bigger mound to get around. It's against the Eagles.
Pass interference, number 20 of the defense, automatic first down.
Brian Dawkins, that makes it first and goal.
You're going to see Brian Dawkins is right there. And again, he has a collision with Eric Bjornsson when the ball's in the air. Dawkins is saying Bjornsson ran into him. It looked like to me that he ran into Bjornsson.
First and goal at the 4. I think that was a good call. Play. Emmitt Smith, the ball carrier, is only out for one play.
Well, there weren't many white jerseys blocking many green jerseys on that play.
Nope. There might have been one holding.
There was. They caught him.
Holding. Number 50 of the offense. 10 yards.
Clay Shiver.
First down.
The offensive center.
Yeah, because a couple plays ago, here's Clay Shiver right there, number 50. And he goes and has his guy right there. Again, I think it's Red Hall trying to get by him. It was Red Hall.
It is.
He hasn't been doing a very good job blocking Rhett Hall all day.
First and goal on the 14. Wade Wilson, the quarterback. Wilson gets to Emmett. And Emmett Smith hurries down to about the 6.
Yeah, that was a pretty good move there. This is the one where they put Larry Allen over here at the left tackle. You see, here's Nate Newton right here, and they just run right behind him. And they pick it off, and they just get good drive on that play and get everything going backwards. In fact, that was George Hegeman who got that block.
Second goal at the 6. Wade Wilson takes the second Dallas timeout of this half, so they only have one left. Hegeman, a good job. He is a big fellow. 6'7", 330 plus.
They came to our planet. They destroyed our cities. But on November 7th, they'll learn they messed with the wrong species.
Shoot them!
Starship Troopers, rated R, opens everywhere November 7th.
Yo quiero Taco Bell.
I'm the road to Canterbury. Hello, dear. Thank you. Of course, you Americans hate the rain.
Oh, it's too wet and scary. Mommy won't let me come out and play.
The road is cold. And the 1998 ES 300 with front-wheel drive and available traction control will help you answer it.
Not bad, but you're on the wrong side of the road!
Halloween screams with a brand new episode plus two classic tales.
Down in front!
It's the Simpsons Scarathon, tonight at 7, 6 Central.
In the rain at Philadelphia's Veterans Stadium, the Cowboys have it third. Second and goal at the 6. Wade Wilson, the quarterback. They have one timeout left in this half. The Cowboys do. Michael Irvin jogging back in motion. Here is Wilson. Penalty and flag. Flag comes flying. Pass was incomplete.
Now that ball was thrown a little low to Mike Irvin. That was going to be to him all the way. Yeah. He was outside. He started in motion.
Ball against him.
Look at Troy Vincent in there. The two of them have been going at it all day.
Offense is pass interference. Number 88, 10 yards. Repeat second down.
10 yards. That moves them back. It's still second and goal after the penalty.
Michael Irvin, he pushed off right there. Just before he made the out cut, he pushed off on Troy Vincent. You know, it used to be that you would bring your shoulder into him and then kind of push off with your shoulder. That time, Michael Irvin just took his left arm and pushed Troy Vincent off, pushed it off with his left arm before he cut to the right.
And then the pass was incomplete. Second and goal at the 16.
Troy Vincent has been on him all day today, but I don't think that he had to do that to get that open.
Walker and Smith behind Wilson. Here comes the blitz. And Wilson is down.
Rhett Hall again. They didn't block Rhett Hall. He came straight up the middle. That'll be his second sack. Well, in fact, he had one and a half. That's his second and a half sack.
He's had a heck of a day.
I know. He's been all over. He's been the guy who's getting the penetration, and you're going to see him right here. He just goes by Nate Newton. He just takes Nate's inside shoulder and just drives right through it. Watch, here's Nate Newton here. He's going to take the inside shoulder right there. Rhett Hall is. He didn't have any help on that inside. Nate knew it. Nate putting his foot in the ground, but Red Hall just whipped him to the inside.
So it's third and goal at the 24. Blitz coming again. They get the ball to Emmett Smith, and Emmett's taken down at the line of scrimmage. Red Hall again made the stop.
Now you wonder where that call came from. I know that, you know, that they had to. On the second down, they got sacked, but you would think that they would take the shot at the end zone on third down, and that was kind of a strange play in that situation. I don't know that maybe the football's not wet. I mean it's wet, and they don't have a lot of confidence in throwing it. But
well, it's been raining throughout the game.
But you would still think that, you know, in that situation, before you kick the field goal, you take a shot at the end zone.
From 43 yards out, Cunningham will try again. And he is good again. And that makes it 12-6. Dallas on top by two field goals. Dallas 12, Philadelphia 6. No touchdowns. Intense face of Bill Bates. He's been doing this for a long, long time. 15 years of covering kicks. Deuce Staley retreats to the back of the end zone and downs it there, and the Eagles will take over at their own 20 with 8:49 left. Next week, it's a Fox NFL Sunday doubleheader. All starts with America's most watched pregame show, and they'll be live from San Francisco for the big game between the Cowboys and the 49ers. We'll be there too, plus other regional action. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, right here on Fox. Check your local listings for the game and time. Game in your area. Just looking at that. Charlie Garner in the Eagle backfield, and he gets the carry, and Garner's got some room. Charlie Garner, 9 yards. Stopped by Brock Marion. Now, for McDonald's game break, let's return to James Brown at the Fox Television Center in Hollywood.
Hey, Pat, San Francisco still continuing, doing the job to New Orleans. Young to J.J. Stokes. Saints have never been shut out two games in a row. May happen. Pat, how are we saying? We'll see you next week.
We look forward to seeing you next week. Garner straight ahead. First down, Philadelphia.
You know, and seeing those 49ers, you know, after they lost Jerry Rice, I think that Steve Young decided that he's going to have to throw the ball to Terrell Owens. He's going to have to throw the ball to J.J. Stokes. And those guys realize they're going to have to get open and step up and be the guy, and they're doing it.
And you can almost see them getting better each week.
I'll tell you, they are better, but they are big, big, big targets.
This is Garner. Charlie Garner to the 40. Brock Marion again had to make the tackle on Charlie Garner.
You know, the thing is, it seems like the Cowboys have been doing things. They've been, you know, returning kicks, and they've been moving the ball down the field. But all the Eagles have to do is score a touchdown and kick an extra point, and they're ahead in this game.
Second and three. Inside handoff to Kevin Turner. They said they had to get the ball in his hands occasionally, and they did. Fred Strickland made the stop. This game is presented by Authority. The National Football League is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Philadelphia Eagles and the NFL is prohibited. First down, Philadelphia at their own 46. Nothing doing this time as Charlie Garner is taken down by Dexter Coakley.
This defense really plays hard. And, yep. You know, we were talking about the job that Dave Campo's done and you know, and blitzing more and playing a lot of young guys. In fact, when they play a nickel defense, they can have as many as 5 rookies on the field at one time.
You're not supposed to be able to do that, but they have had that situation. There's Rodney Peete. He gets it to Erling Pryor. That was not his fault. That was Pryor.
Yeah, and that was kind of a little different ball handling. You know, The Eagles thought that on Deion Sanders, you can run slants and crosses, and they weren't going to stay away from him. They're just going to stay away from him on some kind of pattern. But watch what Rodney Pete does. He does a complete circle.
A pirouette.
Yeah, he does a pirouette before he throws that, then whaps it in there.
That's a good throw.
And as you said, that was Irving Fryer's fault. He dropped that ball because he had Deion Sanders beaten on that slant.
Three wide receiver set up. Pete. Incomplete. Intended for Michael Timpson, who slipped down, and the Eagles are going to have to punt.
Yeah, we talked to the officials before the game, and they have 36 footballs for this game, 18 for the first half and 18 for the second half, and they were, the big thing is to keep the football dry, but I'll tell you, the quarterbacks look like they're having a little trouble throwing it, and the receivers are having a little trouble catching it.
More than a little.
A lot of trouble.
Deion Sanders back deep, Hutton to punt it. Deion retreats to the 10, lets the ball bounce, and it rolls into the end zone. The Cowboys will start from their own 20 with one timeout and 5:56 left, leading by 6.
Lessons you've learned. That most men don't do laundry. Because washing machines don't come with a remote control. And the only time your boss returns your phone calls is when you're not there. And happiness isn't how much you have, but your ability to enjoy what you've got.
I am everyday people.
If I had my way, there would be no punting on fourth down. No throwaway passes. I would never be told to slide or step out of bounds. Safeties would learn to fear my footsteps. And history books would not refer to me as a quarterback, but as a football player.
How bad is it?
Dead.
How dead?
Dead. Check out the flame mail.
How many hits so far?
Millions, billions, who knows?
We should have upgraded the server.
Can't. It's not scalable.
What now?
Lock the door.
Night. Has Hank Hill made a pact with the devil?
It just tears my heart out.
A screaming new King of the Hill tonight at 8:30, 7:30 Central.
Fox NFL Sunday is brought to you by Pizza Hut. Enjoy today's game with the Edge Pizza, new from Pizza Hut. 16 pieces of pure toppings. Have you been to the Edge?
Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. It's been raining since the game began, a steady rain. 12-6, Dallas leading the Eagles. Emmett Smith tripped up after he picked up a couple by Hollis Thomas.
Yeah, we were talking about these footballs and if they really are keeping them dry. I mean, the passing game doesn't look like it because in the second half, the net passing for the Cowboys has been 9 yards. The net passing for the Eagles has been 4. Rodney Pete's been 1 out of 7. And I don't know that it is the ball. I'm not making excuses for him, but that's the worst kind of ball to throw is a wet ball.
They had a lot of passes dropped. Here comes a blitz. Emmitt Smith gets the carry and is tripped up behind the line of scrimmage. Lost maybe a yard. Darian Connor made the hit that brought him down. Clock is running, however.
Yeah, this Eagle defense has done an outstanding job. I mean, the special teams have hurt him, but they've really been stuffing the run for the most part, although Emmitt Smith has over 100 yards, and they've been pass rushing, and Troy Vincent has been outstanding today against Michael Irvin.
Third and 8. They're 3 out of 12 on third down conversions. Irvin goes in motion. Brooks in the pitch back to Emmitt Smith. He'll get some yards, but not quite a first.
Now they were going to run at Richard Dent. Richard Dent was in there as a pass rushing specialist, and he was going against Larry Allen. and Richard Dent just takes off up the field. You want to hear, he's going to take off up the field. They get him inside and just pitch the ball outside. Nate Newton pulls around to try and lead to get a first down. That's the second time the Cowboys have had that ball on third down and gone to the run.
Mark Say back deep for the Eagles. They'll get the ball back with 4.5 minutes left. The flag on the play. They might have taken too much time. That'll stop the clock. It's 4:30.
Ball start.
I think the Cowboys
are moving.
Right. Yeah.
5 yards. It's still 4-7.
Yeah, it was the right side. It was either the right guard or the right tackle. Started moving like he was going into pass protection. And then we talk about the Cowboys having good special teams. They have very good coverage teams.
They really do. They back up 5.
This is where Billy Davis is usually one of the first guys down there and making a tackle.
Better kick by Nolan. Out of bounds. Next week we'll be in San Francisco. There's a flag on this play. Back at the original line of scrimmage. Going to be holding against the Eagles.
Holding number 22 of the receiving team. 10 yards. First down, Philadelphia.
That's a tough one. A critical one.
That is a tough one because that one had to be during the play or in post possession. You know, so it's the same type of thing. You know, when did it happen? It happened after the kick. That's just a
Deuce Daly,
match.
Yeah. And Billy Davis.
Well, I said Billy Davis was going to be the first guy down there, and Deuce Daly wasn't going to let him be the first guy down there.
That was another one of those post-possession fouls, so it'll be the Eagles' ball.
Yeah, right. The penalty was after the ball was kicked.
Right.
They weren't going to let Billy Davis get there, but Billy Davis was on the other side anyway.
Garner in the backfield. Here's the rush. It's screen pass to Garner. And he is upended and stayed on his feet somehow until he's taken down finally.
Yeah, Randall Godfrey played that well, yep, though, for the Cowboys. That's the thing on the screen. You have to get right out there and watch Randall Godfrey. He's number 56. He's gonna see it. He's gonna feel it. He's sliding right down the line. Then he gets here. Now watch him get the penetration right there. He made Charlie Gardner stop so that a bunch of his friends could get over there and make the tackle. But that play was made by Randall Godfrey.
Antonio Anderson has led the pursuit. Here is Pete. He gets the ball outside to Kevin Turner. Turner still on his feet. And Turner into Dallas territory, out of bounds at about the 42. Randall Godfrey knocked him out of bounds.
Well, Ray Rhodes was saying that they like to get the ball to Kevin Turner early, and that was the first time they've gotten it to him today. That's Kevin Turner's first catch. Watch him. He comes out there. They just throw that ball out there, and he gets the thing out flank, and then he makes Kevin Smith miss on a tackle and then just goes right up the sideline.
First down, Eagles at the Dallas 42. Cowboys leading 12-6. Pete to Ricky Waters. No gain. Well, is Deion Sanders excited about something?
It looked like he thought there was,
yeah,
a penalty. Unless he was just excited about coming in there and stopping him for no gain. You know, that's one thing that everyone thinks they can do against the Cowboys, is they don't think that Deion is a good tackler. Now, he doesn't enjoy tackling as much as the other part, but he is a good tackler, and everyone tries to get him up and force and run at him.
He's just not a very aggressive tackler, but he is very sure. Here's Rodney Pete to Fryer, and Fryer can't find the handle.
And that's the second one,
yeah,
in a row that Irving Fryer has dropped.
That makes you think that the ball has to be very slippery.
Or the gloves or something.
Something,
because,
yeah.
You know, he made, remember earlier in the game, he made such a great one-handed catch, and then he's dropped two perfect passes right into his hands.
Those right there, 3rd and 11.
And the Eagles are in a position now that they have to think of 3rd and 11, but they have to think in terms of 2 downs. They don't have to get this all on 1 down, because they will have to go for it on 4th down because they need a touchdown.
They send Fryer in motion again. Pete has good protection, and the pass is incomplete. Thrown up the middle to Irving Fryer, who had it in the basket and lost it.
You see, Brock Marion tried to help Irving Fryer up, and Irving Fryer would have no part of that. But the ball's thrown in there. Brock Marion is right there. I think that one's dropped also.
Yes, it is.
Irving Fryer has really dropped three in a row. Watch Brock Marion. He's going to go to help him up, and Irving Fryer says, no, thank you.
He wants none of that.
He wasn't going to. This is a big down. This is a game right here.
Right here. 2:45 left. Pete retreats. And the pass is caught. That's close to a first down. It depends on where they spot it.
Oh, you're exactly right. Where they spot it. Where that guy put his right foot. He hasn't put it down yet. This official, the second official there, where he's going to put that foot. Oh, is this close?
It's a big, big call.
Because if it's not a first down, it's a Cowboys ball.
Well.
Oh, and then do they put it at the toe or the heel? Do they put it at the front of the foot or the middle of the foot or the back of the foot?
Is that left foot? There's something about that left foot that I remember.
Yeah, it was a right foot then.
Right foot?
That was a right foot job that he got there.
Well, we'll see. The life of a coach.
First down. You talk about a game of inches and a spot. I mean, how does that guy come in there and just put his foot down? If he puts his left foot down, that wouldn't have been a first down. He did give him the right foot job on that one, and a first down for the Eagles.
Today's game is being produced by Bob Stenner, directed by Sandy Grossman. The associate director is Mike Roy. Broadcast associates are Fran Morrison and Charles McDonald. Technical producer Bob Muller. Studio was produced by Scott Axelson and directed by Bob Levy. Senior producers Bill Brown. The executive producers are Fox Sports' Ed Gorin and David Hill. Timeout. Philadelphia. That leaves them with two.
It's freezing. It's quiet. But you get used to it. You grow to love it.
Snowfox 2-1. This is Snowfox Base.
This is Snowfox 2-1.
Then a storm comes up. And I'm the one who's got to get us out of here. And I remember who gave me courage. This is for them. For my mom and dad, who never missed a game. For Drill Sergeant McCardle, who showed me what it takes to be a leader.
A visual contact, Sergeant.
And for myself, who became one.
We showed you coach's reaction. How about the player's reaction? Charlie Garner,
You see how they lined up? They like a plumb bob. They were plumb bobbing that line there.
Oh, boy.
I don't think Troy Aikman is plumb bobbing that line.
Not jumping and leaping by Troy Aikman.
I think he's still woozy from that slight concussion that he had in the first half.
First down, Eagles at the Cowboy 32-yard line. Rodney Pete to throw. Here's a screen pass. This time it's to Turner. And Kevin Turner fights his way to the 25 and out of bounds.
They'll get the two-minute warning
Warning. Not sure what he's upset about. Maybe he thinks he should have broken it. Cowboys 12, Eagles 6. 2 minutes left. The Eagles have two timeouts remaining. They have the ball at the Cowboy 25. Pat Summerall here with John Madden. Barry Switzer looking on. Second and three. A lot of people looking on. The handoff is to Waters. Ricky Waters out of bounds. Lost the ball, but out of bounds at the 12. Waters came back in and picked it up.
You can't go out of bounds and be the first guy to come in and touch the ball.
You can if you fumble it.
Of course, the ball has been blown dead anyway. But watch Ricky Waters here. He's fired up now. He's starting in there. He hits that six hole perfectly. Barrett Brooks gets a block for him, and he just runs right through it.
I don't know if the ball is out of bounds or not. The Eagles ready to run another play. In any case, this is Waters to about the eight. Clock is running.
You know, you just have a feeling that Irving Fryer is still going to make a play. I mean, Irving Fryer is a big playmaker. Irving Fryer has dropped the last three passes to him. He's dropped four passes in this game, and great players don't end games like that.
Eagles have just put in Chad Lewis at tight end, and he is a pass receiver.
Receiving tight end.
Yep. Second and seven, the Eagles. Less than a minute left now. Rodney Pete back to throw it. Fires it. Touchdown. Chad Lewis. Pete to Lewis. It's 12-12.
Chad Lewis is the Eagles have three tight ends, Jimmy Johnson, Jason Dunn, Chad Lewis. Chad Lewis is the rookie, but he's also the pass receiving tight end.
The rookie from Brigham Young. And now Boniol's extra point to give the Eagles the lead. Hutton puts it down. Flag on the play. Boniol's extra point was good, but there's a penalty marker down.
And the way the Eagles are going, it looks like it's against them. You know, that was the first pass caught by an Eagle tight end in this game.
Penalty was against the Cowboys. Chad Lewis, who just made the touchdown catch.
The extra point is good. The penalty is administered on the kickoff.
45 seconds left. 13-12, Philadelphia leading.
Rodney Pete has hung in there this whole game. He's had balls tipped. He's had balls dropped. He's been sacked. But the first pass that he throws to a tight end or the first completion to a tight end is a rookie from BYU. Chad Lewis, he just runs a slant, and he gets that ball. But Chad Lewis, he's up on top, and they started with three, and he's going to be right here and come right down here. You see, he started to the outside. The defender fell down.
Slipped down.
That was a heck of a move. He started like he was going outside to the corner and then just came right back into a tight post.
The Eagles lead by a point.
You get a player from BYU, and he's caught a lot of passes.
Yeah.
Rodney Pete saw that whole thing. He was watching Chad Lewis. That was going to be his guy. And he watched him all the way and hit the big target. As I said, the Cowboys had chances to put the Eagles away all day, and the Eagles fought, and they fought, and they fought, and they hung in there, and then this happened. But this is not one of the strengths of the Philadelphia Eagles right now, Pat.
The special teams, the kick coverage is not one of their strengths. That's so true. The kickoff sails in the direction of Herschel Walker. And Walker is taken down at about the 24-yard line by Brian Dawkins. Flag on the play. The Eagles, if they hang on, and this penalty is against Dallas, if they hang on, will be 4-4, and so will Dallas be 4-4.
And you know the thing about the Eagles, if they do hang on, as you say, they'll be 4-4. They've won all four games at home. They will have lost all four games in a row.
Here's the kickoff return. Number 99.
It depends on, and we haven't seen what happened to the Giants. We haven't seen what happened to the Redskins, but they're all bunching up in the NFC East.
And I thought that, you know, we know there's going to be a separation, and I felt that this week would be the start of the separation.
And as far as these two teams are concerned, it's the start of a bunching together.
Listen to this crowd. They want these Cowboys. They hate the Cowboys here in Philadelphia.
That's true in a lot of places. Wade Wilson gets the pass to Emmitt Smith. 30 seconds left.
The Cowboys only have one timeout. I think they got to get the ball to the outside. I mean, they have to give the ball to Michael Irvin here. Wade Wilson better hurry up.
Wilson back to throw. Gets the ball to Emmitt Smith again, and he gets out of bounds. Stops the clock with 14 seconds left.
Yeah, they don't have time to be throwing loops to the back. They got to get the ball outside to their wide receivers. There's Ernie Zampezi over there in the corner calling the plays. Barry Switzer's thinking to himself, it looks like we let another one slip away. But the Eagles fought them all day. I mean, the Eagles did. I mean, the Eagles came here to fight, and they fought them all day.
They let them hang around.
And they hung around and bit them at the end.
Four field goals. Here's Wade Wilson, spins away, and now ducks under a couple of Eagle tacklers. And takes the sack with 7 seconds to go, and the Cowboys call the timeout. Philadelphia 13, Dallas 12.
Wade Wilson is going to go over there and try and get one more play that he can just hope that he can get a defensive penalty on here. Here you see they're just playing that prevent defense, and isn't it funny how when a prevent defense works, no one jokes about it. When you beat a prevent defense, they say all it does is prevent victory.
Why did you use that defense? Why did you slow things down?
The Eagles have used a lot of defenses and used a lot of defense as well.
And their defensive unit and the Cowboys' defensive unit. When you only score one touchdown and there's so little time left before you score it, both defenses have done well. Here's...
You see that smile on Rodney Peete's face?
Yep.
It's been a heck of a week for him, hasn't it?
Has it ever. Twins and a victory. How much better can it get? Healthy twin. This is just a jog out of bounds by Emmitt Smith and the Eagles. Remember how they beat Green Bay back in the first of the year when we were here? 10-9. And now it's 13-12. And the Eagles and the Cowboys are tied at 4-4.
Look at this place here. This crowd's going wild. There's fireworks. There's cannons going off. This is football.
It's been raining since the game started.
Yeah,
but these people don't know it.
Frost and the pumpkin.
Frost is washed off by now.
Yeah, and you talk about, you know, what football is all about and the NFL is all about. It's about, you know, tradition, and it's about great rivalry games. And when you get the Eagles and the Cowboys, that's one of them.
Well, you think about the last 2 weeks for Rodney Peete and his starts with the Eagles. They beat Arizona last week in overtime, and this week it's by a point. 13-12. Philadelphia over Dallas. There's the guy who caught the pass.
We talked about their defense, the job Troy Vincent did. We talked about the job Rhett Hall did.
Let's send you now down to Carl Churkin.
Thank you very much, Pat. Eagles continue to congratulate Rodney Peete. Chad Lewis, who just caught that touchdown. First half, you were behind people. Second half, they dropped him, but you got the one that you needed.
Yeah, that's the story of our season so far. You know, you got to fight all the way to the end, and every game we play is going to be close. You know, there's not going to be any easy ones. And you look around the NFL, and there's very few easy ones. And you keep playing for 60 minutes, a good thing's going to happen to you.
Rodney, this team looked lifeless until Mark Stay's punt return. What effect did that have?
Well, they got a pretty good defense on the other side. I mean, they're not a bunch of losers over there. I mean, they got some great players, and they made some plays on us. But the game was close. Thank God for our defense for keeping it close and getting us a chance at the end.
Rodney, congratulations. You can tell the Twins you got to win. First day there. Okay. Back upstairs to you, Pat.
All right, Chad, thank you very much. Michael Zordich.
There's a real warrior, isn't there? Michael Zordich.
He's met his family yesterday.
Yeah. His father was there and his brother was there. And he's a real player.
Any doubt about what's the play of the game? Here it is, brought to you by Energizer. From Rodney Peete to the rookie tight end Chad Lewis.
And Chad Lewis, you know, made a heck of a move. I mean, you know, part of all receiving is getting off the line and then getting open. But the part that he made of getting open, that move was something special.
It really was. Special to him and special to the Eagles and their fans. They win 13-12 over the hated Cowboys.